Are you dealing with a personal injury? Don't go it alone. Turn to the experienced team at Phillips Law Firm. Their attorneys have helped thousands of clients get the compensation they deserve. Call Phillips Law Firm now. Call 1-800-JUSTICE or visit justiceforyou.com.
Most of you listening right now are probably multitasking. Yep, while you're listening to this, you're probably also driving, cleaning, exercising, or maybe even grocery shopping. But if you're not in some kind of moving vehicle, there's something else you can be doing right now. Getting an auto quote from Progressive Insurance. It's easy, and you could save money by doing it right from your phone. Drivers who save by switching to Progressive save nearly $700 on average. And auto customers qualify for an average of 7 discounts. Discounts for having multiple vehicles on your policy, being a homeowner, and more. So just like your favorite podcast, Progressive will be with you 24/7, 365 days a year. So you're protected no matter what. Multitask right now. Quote your car insurance at progressive.com to join the over 29 million drivers who trust Progressive. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. National average 12-month savings of $698 by new customers surveyed who saved with Progressive between June 2021 and May 2022. Potential savings will vary. Discounts not available in all states and situations.
Hey, this is BJ. Thanks for listening to our show's podcast. If you're a fan of all things geeky, you should check out my other podcast, BJ Shea's Geek Nation. We have new episodes every day, and you can check it out at bjgeeknation.com.
Your home is going into foreclosure, and you feel like a financial wreck. You don't know where to turn for accurate information. I'm bankruptcy attorney Travis Gagne. Let's talk about some legal options. If we work quickly, we can propose a plan to save your home, modify the loan, or in many cases, even eliminate your second mortgage. The consultation is free. I've helped hundreds of people just like you make informed decisions about whether to save their home or exit it on a reasonable, organized timeline. The chapter you choose sets the tone for the next chapter of your life. Please contact me today at ChooseTheRightChapter.com. That's ChooseTheRightChapter.com.
99.9 KISW, the Rock of Seattle. I love this. When you've got social media and you've got the ability to basically become a star in anything you want to do, especially video, because of just the technologies right on your phone a lot of times.
Yeah.
That means anybody in any profession can really stand out in a way that might infuriate the normal way people think that profession should go. And one thing I'm thinking about is real estate, because we got two dudes that used to work on the radio, Ron and Don, that now do real estate.
Right.
And why wouldn't they?
Sorry.
But I mean, the way that they do it is I watch their stuff and go, I don't remember realtors ever even doing anything like this to sell houses. But these guys, I think, have done a great job, like, turning it on its ear.
Well, dude, it's so funny you bring this up, because yesterday I was just on Instagram and somebody I'm friends with, they're a real estate agent, and she just posted like an Instagram video, and I was like, this is brilliant. Like, it was a super fun, entertaining, quick video about the process that you go into in purchasing a home. And I'm like watching this thing. I'm like, you know, obviously I'm not looking to buy a house again.
It's time.
I hope that it's never going to have to happen
again. I feel like it's time for you.
I like for this to be the forever home, BJ.
Okay,
especially
fine.
Since the neighbors that park everywhere are moving out.
So it is the forever home.
It's a good time to be alive in Steve's home. But I saw him like, you know, if I didn't have a realtor, I would totally hit her up, because it's creative and it's different and it was informative.
Well, you got to head to the BJ and Migs page of KISW.com, because there's this realtor in England who's gone viral with her parody video. And it's basically a parody of video tour of this house. And what she does is she walks room to room during her own version of that 80s hit, The Neverending Story.
Oh, boy.
This old house.
Oh, God.
There's so much here to see. Covered with these beams. Maybe you're a family with growing teenage kids. This home has lots of options to all watch your own Netflix. The never-ending property.
Oh, what the hell is happening?
I love this lady.
I don't know if I hate this or love this.
I love this lady.
I kind of hate her voice, but I like the idea.
I like when her accent pops through, though.
Isn't that funny? It's so interesting. I noticed that too, Steve. It's like a lot of times when English people sing, they don't have an accent.
I didn't notice the accent until the chorus.
Property.
Yeah.
Property.
I don't know if I'd buy a house from her, but I sure as hell want to see more parody songs from her.
I love her. I would buy a house from her.
I would definitely buy a house from her, because sometimes, like, I guess I'm an adult technically. I feel like when I talk to other adults, I either don't get taken seriously or I just feel really dumb talking to them. I feel like she would dumb it down enough for me.
So at least
she would sing for you.
Yeah. I would understand things. It'd
Here's
be perfect.
Your mortgage payment.
Oh my gosh. That
I love
is so
her.
Funny.
Oh, Danny does not. No, Danny is. Danny, you know what?
What if she did a Simple Plan song?
Yeah. In.
Okay.
Oh,
okay.
But again, change her voice. Like, her voice.
It was The Voice.
Yeah.
Oh, you don't like The Voice, huh?
I'm not going to let her through on The Voice if I was, like, you know, a judge.
No.
But I sure as hell am interested in seeing what she has, some future songs that she's going to write about homes.
Yeah, I think she sings better than all of you.
Not me.
Yeah, that's true. I feel like it's close.
I mean,
that's
not even close. What are you talking about?
All right, let's hear it. Here, let's. What do you got?
We're not gonna take it.
Oh, yeah, you're right.
I take Steve's voice,
we
honestly.
Ain't gonna take
that's right.
It.
Oh, wait, this is honestly? You take his voice over her voice?
Bye, house
you.
Today.
Yeah.
Okay, no, thank you.
Yeah.
If I had to
I'm throwing
to
my
Steve
dollars soon. At Steve all day.
You throw your dollars
not the
at
first
Steve.
Time.
I don't want to hear Steve singing me real estate. I think I would demolish the house that Steve was selling just to get him to stop singing about
I'm
it.
I'm just trying to now think of like a song that would be a good parody, like, you know.
But for a house?
Yeah.
Oh, well, the Never-Ending Property seemed like a...
The Never-Ending Property was a little bit of a stretch.
All right, yes it was.
I think it's a little on the nose, but our house...
That was
there you go.
Already on the nose.
I was also thinking like the Bloodhound, we don't need no water, let the mother blanker burn.
That's going to sell to a specific audience.
Yeah, I don't know why.
Seems like I only got 2 clicks on this video, and only one person ever wants to buy from me.
There was a really bad techno song when I brought it up before. It's like, girl, I'll house you, girl.
Oh, that's what okay.
It's just a terrible dance song.
It surely is. I wish I could help you out with this, but I really don't know if I have any good songs to parody.
Home, sweet home.
Oh, okay.
And you got Tommy Lee's Dong sing it.
There you go.
Again, I think a specific audience, but go for it.
See, I was thinking Take Me Home, the Country Roads.
Oh,
John
the old
song.
John Denver tune.
But it has to be like a really like cool old house.
What about the Take Me Home Tonight?
That'd make me
want to do something else.
Eddie Money.
Okay, Eddie Money.
Yeah, the Eddie Money tune.
Sweet
that works.
Home Alabama.
If you're selling houses in Alabama, why not?
Well, you could change Alabama.
Sweet Home Tequila.
Yeah. Or Tequila, yeah.
Magnolia is better.
Yeah. Okay, wow. And you're making fun of her saying the Never Ending Property. Come on,
I could do better. Look, I said Steve could
feel
do
like
better.
You didn't.
Yeah. We're fleshing these ideas out. We have yet to commit to recording them.
Yeah, I think you should be committed. Yes, both of you. I think that's a great idea. And let's get on that. Well, there you go. The singing realtor. Luckily for all of you, if you hate her, she's in England, so you never have to worry about it.
I wonder how much business she's getting from this, though.
Oh, I mean, I hope this is a thing she does. Like, she realizes, holy cow, if this is her first video that she's ever done.
Yeah.
Oh, man, like you said, you've given her a lot of great ideas for different parody songs to sell homes.
And would you show up to the house? I would go there just solely so I could, like, be like, I like to see the Never Ending Property.
Oh, definitely. Yeah. I would.
Right.
Oh, man. And then what if she becomes huge and gets, and then that's what she does. She doesn't sell houses anymore. She just goes for other realtors and says, I want to do a video of your home sale and I'll post it. And that's how she gets paid.
There's so many ridiculous ways people have gotten rich. And then when you hear about it, you're like, how did that even become a thing? This could be easily one of those things where, like, all of a sudden she starts singing a few, sells a couple multi-million-dollar homes, and boom. She's done.
See, Vicky and I, which scares me to think that I am close to Vicky in this kind of entertainment because she's an old lady in a young person's body, really scares me to think this. But yeah, I'm with Vicky. I would watch these videos.
Yep.
Yeah. All and right. You two horrible people.
Wait, I said I like the video.
Steve's in.
Well, yeah, you're projecting this anger.
Because Danny's always your buddy, and I know he'll turn you to the dark side.
All I said is I'm not going to put her through to the next round on The Voice.
That's what I'm saying.
But this isn't The Voice.
Yeah. Wow, you two of you, man. Vicky and I had nothing to say about her
That
voice.
Would be funny if that's the route she took instead. Like, she was like, you know what? This went viral. People must love my voice. Might as well show up on American Idol or
right.
The Voice.
Pop Idol over there is what they have. So, yeah. Yeah, Simon Cowell can, like, I don't know if he's still doing it over
there. Pop Idol?
That's what they used to call it. I think that's where American Idol started, it was British Pop Idol over there, if I'm not mistaken.
Well, she can do that.
Yeah. Hello?
I won't vote for her.
Wow. Yeah, that's your guy over there, Steve.
So? He's allowed to have an opinion.
He's your henchman. You don't understand.
He's allowed to have his own opinion.
He's your henchman. He reflects badly on the Steve administration.
No, that's all in your head, man.
Oh, I'm keeping it right there, too. We got a school principal. I cannot wait to hear about this. A school principal had to resign after she was scammed out of $100,000. This school principal had to resign. Steve is going to tell you all about this. He's got the Migs report for you at 617 on The Rock.
BJ and Migs, mornings on The Rock, 99.9 KISW.
Give dads and grads the gift of relaxation with Hand and Stone Massage and Facial Spa. Dads and Grads Season Ticket to Relax offers $30 off a massage or facial gift card or $70 off a massage and facial gift package. With 8 Seattle area locations, it's easy to find the one nearest you or explore exclusive online gift card sales. Let Hand and Stone help dads and grads restore, relax, and reset. Restrictions apply. See spa for more details.
99.9 KISW, The Rock of Seattle.
If you're hearing an informative newscast right now, well, then you must not be listening to BJ and Migs. Live from the KISW News Center in downtown Seattle, this is the Migs Report.
Well, thanks, you guys. Thanks to Palace Law for giving us the Migs Report. And today is the day to head outside, BJ. Take a walk in the park day.
Oh.
Possibly T-Mobile Park. Opening day's happening today.
That's right, man.
You got to go to a park? I think that's the one you got to go to. Is it really a park? No. But there's grass. Play ball.
Well, when you think about it, though, it's got everything a park has.
It does.
It has grass and people playing it.
Yep, that's true. There's also a little kids zone for, like, you know, with like little slides and things along those lines. If you pick the right game, you can bring your dog.
You can have a picnic there.
That's
right,
point.
In your seat.
Yeah. I mean, you can sit on the grass. It's frowned upon. Security will kick you out, but you can do it.
Yeah, that's a good point. Yeah.
If you try hard enough. It's also National I Am In Control Day.
What? Ooh, I like this day.
I don't know if that's then a day for the Doms or the Subs. I mean.
Oh, it's the Doms, right?
Well, it could be also for the Subs. Like, today's the one day that they take control.
Oh, so it's a script flipper.
Because every other day is I'm In Control Day for the Doms.
I mean, perfect for switches.
Yeah, there you go.
Oh,
is that the game system?
Yeah, Nintendo, yeah, right? Yes.
Okay. Is that a switch? Yes. What you spank people with? Is that what
you're
saying?
No, it means you do both.
Oh, okay. Because I know a switch sometimes is used in that play. You know,
yes,
a little switch play. Not
it's
that I know anything about this, but yeah.
National Doctor Day, so you can play doctor too, DJ.
Oh, hello.
Do whatever you want. But let's talk about the biggest idiot I think ever in a school system.
Oh,
it's
I
a
like
principal,
this.
A principal by the name of Dr. Jan McGee. I feel bad for her because her name's out there, and I think everybody would agree that she might be just one of the dumbest people because she fell for a ridiculous scam. And again, she is the principal of a charter school in Florida, and she was forced to resign because she fell for an online scam where she sent $100,000 to somebody who said they are Elon Musk.
Oh, my God. And, dude, you also said she's a doctor, which means she's got her PhD, right? Isn't that what that means?
A PhD in stupidity.
Wow.
I believe is what
that's rhyming.
Well, anyways, apparently she was talking to Elon, not the real Elon. I mean, all fairness, maybe this person said that they were Elon. They bought Twitter Blue, so they got the check mark, and she's like, he's verified. It says Elon Musk 69 as his user handle. Elon jokes about 69. You never know. Yeah. I mean, it's an honest mistake.
$100,000 is a lot of money to send to anybody, though.
Well, yeah. So apparently she sent $100,000, or she tried to his right-hand man, a man by the name of Luis Alberto Fernandez.
Oh, right. We all know Luis Alberto Fernandez. He's verified right-hand.
He's been Elon's guy for as long as she's been getting scammed. And she fired off a check from the school's account.
Oh.
See, she wasn't trying to make the money herself.
Oh, boy.
She was hoping that by, like, I guess they were going to do, like, a matching funds type of thing because she wrote that in the memo line. And I guess the deal was, hey, we send you $100,000. Eventually, you get $6 million in return, which you would give the school. Her heart was in the right place, BJ.
Her brain wasn't.
That is very true. Well, apparently, this isn't like something that she just did like as a knee-jerk thing. She's been like talking to Elon for a while. She let even some of the school officials know, and they're all like, hey, Jan, this is not real. do not do this. Like, everybody was telling her.
Okay, so she was letting people know, and they were telling her, don't do this.
Yes.
Okay, this is even worse now.
So then eventually, she tried to do it. Thankfully, I guess the school's business manager caught wind of what was going on. I was like, yeah, we're going to stop that check before it gets cleared. And they stopped the check.
Wow.
So they avoided what could have been a really... a fortunate thing for Luis was that the guy's name, Luis Alberto Fernandez. But yeah, they ended up not getting the money. They did a big investigation. And well, she talked in front of the school board members and resigned. And here's that audio.
I am a very smart lady, well-educated. I fell for a scam. I put myself into this position and into this mess, and I made a bad decision.
You think?
Dude, I've seen so many examples of this because my wife has a lot of smart friends, and sometimes I cannot believe the decisions they make.
Not everybody's, maybe you're book smart, but common sense stupid.
Yeah. You remember I've told you about the money scam when my wife wanted to go behind a bank and give
herself... Yeah, for the dong.
For the dong. And the friend who told her to do this has a PhD.
Yeah.
Like, again, a doctor.
It's stupidity.
Yeah. I scratch my head because I feel like I'm dumb because I don't have a PhD. You just make assumptions, like you said, that people who are book smart, they're not smart everywhere else sometimes.
No. Some of them get into arguments with bots on Facebook. You just never know what's going to happen.
Those people, I mean, that's the dumbest of the dumb right there.
Well, anyway, here's a board chairperson for the school talking about what happened.
Somehow she believed it, matching funds with this guy, and he was supposed to give like $6 million to the school.
Yeah. Farewell, Jan.
Dude, I'm telling you, that's the kind of languaging that my wife thought she was going to invest like, you know, $1,000 to $10,000 and get millions back.
And the best part is, like, she's like, my heart's in the right place. I'm just trying to get the school $6 million. And they're like, yeah, you know what? We'll just keep our $100,000, dummy.
Yeah. That kind of return would be criminal.
Well,
I mean, that's really, think about it.
Yeah.
5% return on your money is average, what they tell you if you are just, you know, in a mutual fund. So think about, what is the return? I don't even know the percentage of you put $100,000 and get $6 million back. That's more than 5%.
A buttload.
Yeah, that's criminal, kids.
Or a boatload. Either one.
Boatload and a buttload all together.
I'd say she's the dumbest person in the news. But you know what? These two teenagers, they're putting up a good case for being pretty stupid as well. They pulled a guy out of his car at a gas station outside of Washington, D.C., trying to carjack him, take his vehicle.
Okay.
And so they're like, okay, get out. We're taking your car. Slight problem. Neither of those kids knew how to drive a stick, and it was a manual transmission car.
Another reason to have a manual transmission, man.
I mean, who needs a carjack for anti-theft? You just need a stick shift, apparently.
That is an anti-theft vehicle. If you don't know how to drive stick, you're going nowhere.
I mean, the two of them are idiots. I mean, it's caught on surveillance footage and all that. Morons. But then again, they also didn't try and give somebody $100,000 hoping to get $6 million.
You're right. They're not the idiots of the day.
How do you feel if you're a principal of a school and you realize that you're still dumber than those two teens?
Yeah. And you have you're a doctor.
Yes.
You've got your doctorate in something.
All right, tonight.
Yeah.
Opening day, woo! Baby. Lame-o! The Mariner season starts. Lame-o! The beginning of the quest for our World Series championship. Oddly enough, there are some places that believe that the Mariners have a very good shot at winning the World Series. It's not just me this year, BJ.
Hooray!
Some places even give them 20-1 odds, which I think is like 9th or 8th best. So like they're considered one of the top teams. And man, tonight we're going to, it's a long season. But tonight we'll get a taste of what the Mariners are all about as they take on the Cleveland Guardians for their first game of the season. Luis Castillo's on the mound. That's always good news. Julio Rodriguez, some believe that he's a favorite to potentially win the MVP this season. Again,
MVP!
We haven't even had one game yet, and already we're talking about MVP, baby. Great pitching staff that they've got. In addition to Luis Castillo, you got Robbie Ray, you got George Kirby, Logan Gilbert. Hopefully Marco does well this year as well. A lot of eyes are on Jared Kelenic. He had a great spring training, but that means nothing until the regular season happens because, you got to hope this guy starts off hot just to kind of get it right in his head because it seems like his mind, what's between his ears, is his biggest enemy.
Yeah, I'll tell you this, dude. I don't know how anybody's making any predictions because of all the rules changes. I'm not sure how you can make predictions about anything. The game of baseball should look very different this year.
And quicker because of the pitch clock, baby.
Yes, sir.
I'm excited about that. So you can go watch that game. Well, tickets are sold out. But, you know, you can watch it in T-Mobile Park or you can watch it on Root Sports.
Yeah, you know that's what's right.
Or you can buy them on the secondary market.
You can buy them on the secondary market. If you got a couple extra dollars, maybe you hit up Dr. Jan, that principal. It seems like she's good with money.
Yeah.
That's good. Yeah. She'll get me good tickets.
Or you can celebrate Mariners' opening day. by going to the Kraken game tonight, which is what Danny V and I are going to be doing.
Oh, wow, that's right. There's competing games.
Both at home. Kraken, they're going to be over at Climate Pledge Arena taking on the Ducks, and that's going to be a very good game. Do you want to watch that game unless you have ESPN Plus? The way to do it is by going to the game.
Oh, another game on ESPN Plus. Huh?
Yeah. It's also Jordan Eberle bobblehead night, where they celebrate the first ever hat trick in team history, which he, of course, scored. That'd be weird if it wasn't him that got the hat trick.
We're going to have his bobblehead, even though it was like Jimmy that got it.
And how about Danny and I were at that game last year? It was against Buffalo when he scored that hat trick. So, of course, we got to be there. And we got to give a shout out to my friend Rob Kaufman. Rob is part of the Kaufman family, and they own Tacoma Twin Rinks. And they have a suite, and they invited us to it.
How about that?
Hey, if you're not doing anything tonight, you want to come, BJ?
I was just going to say, they invited you guys.
You're more than welcome to come if you'd like to.
Oh, thank you for letting me know, like, day of, which, well, you know, is really hard for me to make plans that way.
We didn't find out until last night.
Yeah. All right, fair enough. That's very sweet.
Yeah.
That's very, very sweet.
Buoy Buddies in full effect. We're going to be there. So.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah,
I'm watching a game from a suite like fancy people.
We are fancy people.
Sometimes.
It's about time people recognize that.
Yeah.
Tell me, you know, I got to know what, like, the kind of food you get up that area.
Yeah.
I know. We'll let you know.
We're excited to hear
about
that.
Take pictures of all the food.
Yes,
it's also our way of not getting banned for asking for another picture with Buoy with our retro reverse jerseys. So, you know, whatever.
Yeah. So if you see two idiots with retro reverse jerseys tonight yelling Buoy, it's probably Danny.
Yeah, that's you guys.
Sure to say hi. We'll be walking around. Go crack it. That's going to be a fun one to watch as well. So good night for the Seattle sports. Hopefully we get two W's. Yeah. And as far as weather, 54 degrees, going to be cloudy. Thanks to Beacon Plumbing, Heating, Septic, and Mechanical for giving us the Migs Report. And that's what's up.
Very nice, man. Very, very cool. By the way, I read, and we're going to talk to Ryan. Have we talked to Ryan Rollins-Smith sometime?
Yes, at 7:17 this morning. Mariners Root Sports analyst and also former Mariners pitcher Ryan Rollins-Smith on the Talk Mariners.
Yeah, you talked about the pitch clock, and the stats are in. They say it shaves about a half hour off a game.
Yeah, and I heard that some people believe that. That was during spring training. It'll probably be a little bit less than that with television timeouts and things along those.
Oh,
you know,
right.
The game gets a little bit longer because of the television side of it all. But still shave probably like 15, 20 minutes off the clock, you'd think.
Yeah.
Maybe even 25.
I love the fact that, you know, I mean, it's great the Mariners are being predicted to do well this year because I have no idea. I think they are because of the rules changes. But again, it's all speculation.
Yep.
I mean, the bases are bigger, which means it'll be easier to steal bases because basically they're closer to each other because they're bigger. And that does make a huge difference. Also, it allows the players to be able to basically touch the base, and difficult for a player to tag you out because the base is bigger. So there's more places for you to touch where they can't reach around and get you. You know about the reach around. It's important. In baseball.
You actually lost me after you said that. Yeah. So started thinking things.
And
Julio, what?
Yeah. And of course, the shift is gone, meaning that guys now will actually get more hits than they used to since they can't put everybody on one side of the field anymore. And that could really be like a guy like Jerry. You know, when you said Kelnick had a great spring, it's like, could it be because of the fact now everyone has to play the position they have to play, and now there's more open space for a guy like him to get hits?
I hope he does well this year, man, because it's just like, seems like that's just one of those things where it's more in his head than anything else.
Yeah, I'm very happy about this because now you're going to see who the real pitchers are. In my opinion, you're going to see
Luis Castillo is the real pitcher, baby.
Yeah, baby. And you're going to see great defense. You're going to see then, I think, like, J.P. Crawford is going to be such a big part of our team. And I think Wong, our second baseman, who's also a good defender. I'm very excited, dude. And we'll talk to Ryan at 7:15.
Also, very excited about all the new food options. I say get in line now if you want to get some of that Moto Pizza because that West Seattle spot.
Oh, I know. I'm so excited.
They're making their debut.
Next week, Steve.
Yeah, you're going.
I'm going next week, buddy.
Are you going to try and get that pizza?
Yes.
Nice.
I bet.
What if the line is so crazy that you're
saying? I know. That's the only problem. But if we go early enough, I think we've got plans to go early enough that I think we should be okay. Because if we're one of the first ones in the ballpark and we're going to, right after work, because it's an afternoon game.
Yeah.
We can leave right after work and walk there.
And just get in there as soon as possible.
At that point, I think our shot is so good to get Moto.
I hope so.
It's crazy because it's a sold out game. But I was like, I said the secondary market kind of jokingly. I just got an email and they're $13 300 level ticket for tonight.
You know, I'm not surprised because it's a Thursday night game.
Yeah, that's what. Yeah,
I bet some season ticket holders aren't able to go, and maybe they're just like, well, we got to put them up for sale.
Yeah, $11.
And
$11.
What's the temperature going to be for tonight? That's the other thing.
Oh, it's going to be in the 50s.
Yeah,
that's not horrible for
now.
No, not horrible.
Hopefully, rain stays away.
Nice hoodie.
Oh, yeah. Like Steve's right, though. As long as it's not too rainy. And obviously, it's not a problem when you're in the park, but getting to the park.
I just, you know, really more concerned about the weather and how it's going to be in a suite at the Kraken game.
Yeah.
Maybe.
Nice and warm. Hope you guys make it okay.
I'm going to dress real warm for it, baby.
Hope you guys will be okay.
If only I had a place to put that jacket, though. Oh, there's this giant suite that will get us.
Wow.
I'm fired up. I'm excited to see what the suite is like at the Kraken.
Oh, I bet the suites are sweet.
I hope so.
I mean, come on. I mean, everything else about Climate Pledge is amazing. Why wouldn't the suites be amazing?
Yeah. Plus, we get to be those fancy pants people that show our ticket to get into the secret entrance.
Yeah. Like that. Oh, I didn't know you get to go to the secret entrance?
Yeah. Well, I don't know. I see people going into an entrance that I assume is for suites.
It's probably a password and everything.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
They probably give you like a back rub as you're walking to the suite.
They probably do,
okay,
yeah.
Okay, you don't like that, but still it's a great thing
I'll
for the rest of us.
I'll take it for just so that I can brag about it.
Well, if it's anything like the suites at Lumen Field, because I got to sit in a suite with the Sounders game, they have TVs in the suite, so we could actually have the Mariners game on as we're watching.
I bet that's going to be happening.
The Kraken game.
Oh, yeah.
Amazing.
Also, there's other places to eat. Ballard Pizza is going to be there as well. So, I think Ballard Pizza is over at the Kraken games.
Yeah, they are.
Yeah, really good pizza.
Wow, it seems like, I feel like there's like a ton of new concessions this year at T-Mobile.
Yeah, Din Tai Fung.
Yeah, DTF. Let me tell you right
now. Chick Boom. That's that place that's all in emojis.
Lil Woody's still there?
Yeah, Lil Woody's is still there.
Awesome. Of course they're still there. They make great burgers.
They also got the value menu.
Ooh.
There's like a place where you can get like the actual affordable stuff like Uncrustables, apple slices, carrots, hummus, pretzels, and more.
And the cheap beer, too, I think, there as well.
Wow.
Yes.
Uncrustables. It also sounds like the health menu, too. Because that's what all the stuff they tell me.
Uncrustables really healthy?
No.
Well, you said carrots and hummus?
Yeah, carrots and hummus are.
What are Uncrustables? I don't even know what those are.
Those are like the Smuckers.
We ate them on the show.
The peanut butter and jelly.
Oh, those are fantastic.
Yeah.
I want them.
Well, you can get them next week.
They sell those at the ballpark?
I actually
think that's pretty awesome. And I think Uncrustables are as healthy as anything. It's bread and jelly and peanut butter. That's not horrible for you, is it?
I mean, it's all in moderation, BJ.
Oh, yeah, well, of course. I mean, that's how I take my drugs, all in moderation.
I mean, I wouldn't say that it's like the go-to for fitness is Uncrustables, but I'm also not going to say no to an Uncrustable.
Yeah, that's right. Oh, man, now I want an Uncrustable right now.
What, you don't want carrots and ranch?
No.
What about some hummus?
Hummus is good. I mean, hummus, I'll take. I like hummus a lot. Yeah. Okay, that's important news.
You'll be focused more on Moto Pizza.
Yeah, I want that Moto Pizza so bad.
Make sure you get the Mr. Pig Pizza. That's their most well-loved one.
Ooh. Oh,
and that's going to be an event because they're going to have a few options. Not all the pizzas there. Just, I think, four options.
Oh, Mr. Pig sounds like it's on its way to a Hawaiian, if you ask me.
Mm-hmm.
Mm, Danny, we'll get that for you.
Good, thanks.
Yeah. Yesterday, Steve, he did get this one wrong.
What type of milk is a basic ingredient in Thai cuisine?
Curry milk.
No.
Goat milk.
No.
I can see almond milk.
No.
Sorry, sir.
Oh, Steve.
Sorry. What's that?
Sorry.
What did I do?
It's all about coconut, buddy. Coconut milk, man.
The real milk.
The real milk?
You want a shot at beating Steve? You got it. 206-803-ROCK. We're playing Beat Migs at 647 on The Rock.
Today's podcast was brought to you by Travis Gagne, bankruptcy attorney. He's here right now and has agreed to answer more of your questions about bankruptcy. What's the difference between filing for bankruptcy and credit counseling?
Credit counseling is a useful process in some circumstances, but it does show up on your credit. In fact, from a credit scoring standpoint, credit counseling shows up just like a bankruptcy, so it's going to affect your credit as negatively as filing bankruptcy. In credit counseling, the idea is that a credit counselor works with your creditors on your behalf to try to lower interest rates or work out payment plans with your creditors to pay back your debt over time. In credit counseling, you almost always pay back 100% of the debt, sometimes at lower interest. And of course, some creditors will participate in that process and some won't. So you're usually left with kind of a mixed result with credit counseling and, of course, a high payment.
Thanks, Travis. If you have more questions about bankruptcy, you can reach out to Travis anytime at ChooseTheRightChapter.com. That's ChooseTheRightChapter.com. Thanks for listening.
You diet, you work out, and still there's that one stubborn spot. Hey, it's Jason. I just went after my stubborn fat by doing Cool Sculpting at Terene Dermatology, Minnesota's top Cool Sculpting provider. Dr. Terene is my dermatologist. We froze my fat, and those fat cells are gone for good. FDA approved. No pain, no downtime. Ranked top doctor 8 years in a row. Trust the experts at Terene Dermatology. Call today, 651-633-6883, and say goodbye to stubborn fat. that.
What you watch depends on what kind of mood you're in. Sometimes you're craving comedies like Friends or South Park, and sometimes you're more into dramas like HBO's Succession and House of the Dragon. There's also cooking shows like Chopped and Beat Bobby Flay, and even movies like The Lord of the Rings and Shazam Fury of the Gods. Well, Max is the streaming destination that has the best of entertainment for whatever mood you're in anytime. And plans start at as little as $9.99 a month. Max, the one to watch. Subscription required. Visit max.com.
T-Mobile's network can help keep you connected to all your favorite podcasts when you're out and about. Whether you're an early bird looking to dive into a daily news podcast or a night owl who wants to catch up on the latest reality TV drama, T-Mobile will keep you connected on their strong and reliable network. T-Mobile covers more highway miles with 5G than anyone. So if you need great coverage, especially when you're on the go, check out T-Mobile. Find out more at T-Mobile.com/CY. That's SEEWHY.
I was scared the night you overdosed, but I was prepared. I brought naloxone with me, and I knew how to use it. I held your hand tight when you woke up because I wanted you to feel safe. Your life is worth saving, friend, and I would save it again if I had to.
Naloxone can reverse an opioid or fentanyl overdose. Carry it with you. For more info, go to PreventOverdoseWA.org. A message from the Washington State Department of Health.
Have you been in an accident that wasn't your fault? Feeling overwhelmed and unsure what to do next? Look no further. The personal injury attorneys at Phillips Law Firm are here to help. Phillips Law Firm understands that accidents can turn your life upside down. That's why they're dedicated to fighting for the compensation you deserve and to making the process as stress-free as possible. Don't wait any longer. Call now, 1-800-JUSTICE, or visit justiceforyou.com.
Whether you're driving, cooking, or doing laundry, Progressive knows the podcasts you listen to go best when they're bundled with another activity, much like how their Progressive home and auto policies go best when they're bundled. Having these two policies together makes taking care of your insurance easier and could help you save, too. Customers who save by switching their home and car insurance to Progressive save nearly $800 on average. That's a whole lot of savings and protection for your favorite podcast listening activities, like going on a road trip, cooking dinner, and even hitting the home gym. Yep, your home and your car are even easier to protect when you bundle your insurance together. Find your perfect combo. Get a home and car insurance quote at Progressive.com today. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. National average 12-month savings of $793 by new customers surveyed who saved with Progressive between June 2021 and May 2022. Potential savings will vary.
Hey, this is BJ. Thanks for listening to our show's podcast. If you're a fan of all things geeky, you should check out my other podcast, BJ Shea's Geek Nation. We have new episodes every day, and you can check it out at bjgeeknation.com.
Your wages are being garnished. We can stop that now. It's hard enough to pay your bills when things are good, let alone when a big chunk of your take-home pay is gone before you even get your check. I'm bankruptcy attorney Travis Gagne, and I can stop the garnishment and get the creditors off your back immediately, often the same day as our consultation. Both Chapter 7 and 13 provide bankruptcy relief, but choosing the right chapter is crucial. In a free consultation, we can create a plan to get your finances back under your control. The chapter you choose sets the tone for the next chapter of your life. Please contact me today at choosetherightchapter.com. That's choosetherightchapter.com.
99.9 KISW, the Rock of Seattle. We've got a trip for you, man. We're sending you to San Francisco to see Iggy Pop. So, and we're not asking a lot of you. Because if you want to try to win this big prize, all you got to do is just listen to us. That's it. As a matter of fact, every hour you listen to The Rock, it's your chance of winning.
And the more you listen, the more chances you get, BJ.
That's how this all works. You just log into KISW, either do it on the Odyssey app, AUDACY, Odyssey, or log into KISW.com, and then you just start listening, and like Steve said, every hour gives you another chance to win. Now I know you might want more info. I got it for you. Go to KISW.com.
Let's play Beat Migs.
It's time to play the game. So everybody scream his name. Beat Migs. Don't be a loser. Whoa. Beat Migs. You're a loser.
Happy Friday, Junior.
Woo! It's Friday, Junior, people.
We made it.
Almost.
But
almost,
it is a good day. We got Mariners and Kraken going on today.
Great night tonight for Seattle sports.
Yeah.
Awful night if you're trying to drive into Seattle.
Right?
Yeah.
Oh, God.
Yeah, I recommend you don't do that.
Well, I'm already doing that.
Yeah.
Some people are lucky they got light rail, man, right near where they are.
That is a nice, a benefit for moments like this.
Yeah. I recommend everyone else, Steve, not do that.
Get
if they don't
early,
have to.
Don't try and get there at the last second.
Yeah, no.
Yeah.
Be safe, be smart. Which is usually nothing that we end up doing here. But moving on, we have George from Yelm. George, are you there?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Awesome. Steve, get out of here.
Goodbye.
Safely. For those playing at home, George has 60 seconds to answer 10 questions. You can pass all you want, but you do only get 3 guesses per question. Are you ready?
Yes.
Who won the most recent World Series?
The Houston Astros.
Correct. What martial arts legend was also a champion cha-cha dancer?
Ooh. Pass.
The word inu in Japanese is Japanese for what common animal?
Inu?
Uh-huh.
Pass.
20 new moons were discovered around which planet in 2019?
Pluto.
No.
Jupiter.
Nope.
Mercury.
No.
Oh.
Steve Carell plays Michael Scott in what sitcom?
The Office.
Correct. What is the full middle name of singer Mary J. Blige?
Jennifer.
No.
Pass.
Shakira was born on February 2nd, 1977. How old is she today?
Whatever.
Oh, God.
45?
No.
Oh.
35?
No.
Oh.
46.
Yes! The final episode of the Oprah Winfrey Show aired in what early 2010s year?
2012.
No!
Oh, man, if you had more time.
That was 3 correct.
Yeah. That's a tough one to ask someone to do a math problem. It eats up so much clock.
That's why you just pass it if you're not comfortable with math.
Oh, really? Is that the strategy?
Yeah.
How about you just stop asking those questions so people have a fair chance?
You do have a fair chance. You pass.
Yeah.
No, math is terrible.
That's why you pass.
Yeah. When you have to sit there and do math in a timing game, I think that is so just. I'm sorry. And it's not just you. It's been done in the history of beat Migs, beat the producer, and I've always hated it.
Oh, well, cool. I'm not going to ask you again.
Thank you.
For any input, Steve, are you ready?
Oh, yes.
Who won the most recent World Series?
Houston Astros.
Correct.
Okay.
What martial arts legend was also a champion cha-cha dancer?
I'm going to go with Bruce Lee.
Yes.
Nice word.
Cha-cha.
The word inu is Japanese for what common animal?
Inu?
Uh-huh.
Sheep.
No.
Cow.
No.
Common what?
Animal.
Dog.
Yes.
Nice.
20 new moons were discovered around which planet in 2019?
That would be Uranus, right?
No.
Wow.
I'm going to go Mars.
Nope.
Jupiter.
No. Steve Carell plays Michael Scott in what sitcom?
The Office.
Yes. What is the full middle name of singer Mary J. Blige?
Jane.
Yes. Shakira was born February 2nd, 1977. How old is she today?
She is 45.
No.
46.
Yes.
There you go, buddy.
The final episode of the Oprah Winfrey Show aired in what early 2010s year?
2012.
No.
2011.
Yes. Stephanie Meyer is best known for writing what book series?
Oh, the places that you'll go.
No.
Twilight?
Yes.
Damn it. I know.
It's okay. You annihilated 7-3.
Yeah. Sorry, George.
Nice win, Steve.
Sorry, Georgie.
I love that you said that to yourself.
All right, yeah. It's nice. Steve does that all the time. My favorite moment with Steve ever is when he rallied himself up at the end of a table as we were getting ready to go out and do our second half of the evening.
Yes.
Nobody noticed it but me, and it was one of the first times I'd ever spent with you out, like, in a bar situation.
That was at one of the radio conventions back in the day when they had, like, they just had wallets that they were willing to just open up for everybody. And it took like 12 of us to a nice steakhouse for a dinner.
Is that in Miami?
I miss those days too. I mean, there's probably something illegal going on that we don't know about.
Oh, sure. Yes.
Yeah. Man, they would just, and it's like anything you want, drinks, food. And I took advantage of that, not only with the steak, but also with the drinks.
Yeah.
Oh.
And I drank so much and I was like, I was starting to fade. And I knew that this was just the start of the night. This was dinner. So I just kind of looked down and go, let's go, Steve. And BJ heard it and thought it was like the most ridiculous thing because I was hyping myself up.
Was this in Miami?
Probably.
Because I think I remember that steak night or that steak restaurant because I was so drunk that I accidentally took home the napkins and it was the fancy cloth napkins.
Well, that's their problem.
Yeah, but I was right there with you, buddy.
It was great. I've never seen anybody be their own hype man.
I got through the night.
You did a good job.
It was a good pep talk.
It was just, let's go, Steve.
Yeah, Coach Steve really he came in at the right time with that halftime talk.
And that was when we decided, okay, Steve is a third-person guy sometimes in his life. He speaks about himself in the third person.
When drunk, yes.
Yeah, nice.
The only one that no one got correct was 20 new moons were discovered around what planet in 2019?
I don't think Saturn was guessed, was
Saturn.
It?
Saturn.
No.
Yeah.
Saturn's got a lot of moons, man.
Mm-hmm. And then side note, with the word Inu for Japanese, it kind of, you could figure Ken Jennings it, as BJ would say, Shiba Inu is a type of dog. It's a Japanese dog, Shiba Inu.
I thought you said emu, so I would have lost so bad.
You would have been so mad.
I would have been
so,
well, yeah, but that's not your fault. I just can't hear very well, so.
They're sassy little dogs. My friend has two of them.
I don't even know what a Shiba Inu is.
Yeah, they look like douchey dogs. Their face has kind of got like a jerk.
It's the Doge dog. You know, the meme dog, Doge? Yes. That's the type of dog it is.
Yeah, it does. It looks like it's got attitude. Like, I'm not happy about anything.
Would be the bad guy dog in like an 80s like, movie. Like in the Karate Kid. If like Johnny had a dog, this would be the dog.
They're actually very cat-like in the sense of they don't really need you. They're just like there. They have that personality.
Oh, wow. A cat dog.
Cat dog.
Don't think I'm yeah, you know what? I mean, not that I'm a fan of dogs anyway, but to have a dog like a cat.
I mean, it's not going to be all over you and bugging you, BJ.
That's not the problem. The problem is the dogs when they bark and they're just jerks.
Apparently, though, they're known as spirited, good natured dogs.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, their face betrays them. They got resting dog bitch faced.
Yeah, no, I know. It looks like they want to fight you.
Yeah. I can appreciate that then. You know what? Maybe I'm going to have a little love for these dogs because I have the same thing. I got RBF.
Yeah.
And I look like I'm always in a bad mood.
You should get one.
You should get one for here.
Yeah.
Oh, that's what I need.
You need a dog in California and you need a dog in Washington.
Bodhi 2.5.
You have to understand that this kid's got stress. I'm trying to manage my stress because when I'm stressed out, I'm not fun to be around.
What kid?
This kid right here.
The old man. I got you.
But the dog can maybe help alleviate that.
Yeah, that's I don't think you understand what dogs and me do. It's stress central.
Dogs and you do.
Yeah. Maybe you just haven't found the right dog.
Oh, I found the right dog to avoid. Your dog, my dog, and everybody else's
my
dog.
My dog is the best dog to deal
what?
With now.
What? Your dog? Oh, that's well, yeah, because your
she's
dog
blind
can't see.
And doesn't have any teeth.
Yeah, I mean, your dog.
She has no idea what's going on.
That's unfortunately, that's the best time to be around your dog. At least for me, anyway.
She's just living the charm life. She just sits around, walks into walls.
Yeah. Oh, dude.
And has a great attitude, though. It seems like she's a lot chiller now.
Something to remember. I mean, I've been around an aging dog, and you talk about what's going on with Lulu, and I'm like, yeah, that is that's what's happened. That would happen to my dog.
And of course, I joke about it now because it was heartbreaking when we first had to realize this. You're just like, oh, this sucks. But like, dude, it's amazing how much dogs adapt. Like, I got to take her for walks, and she's, like, way easier to take on a walk now because she's not already, she doesn't give an F about what's around her. Like, she's not freaking out on anything.
Isn't
she's
that
just,
great?
Like, she's just, like, chill and walks and just is, like, happy to be out and about.
That is a lesson for humanity, especially
to lose our vision.
Well, to actually somehow dumb down our senses, because people like Vicky and myself, we're hyper aware, and you know, it's we see things that other people don't see, and then we trip out.
Well, you're a few years away from being like blind and toothless,
dude. So I know, honestly,
we're almost there.
Dentures and contacts.
I almost said that in Namaste with BJ.
I forget things a lot, or I sometimes don't notice things like I used to, and I'm like, wow, this is awesome, because I know I'd be pissed about that if I remembered. Dude, Danny, I'm telling you, it is the greatest gift ever to somehow not be as sharp as I used to be.
I know. Someone's saying a Shiba Inu dogs are actually jerks. For real, they have terrible attitudes.
Oh, so look at this. Look at this internet campaign to tell us the untruths about the Shiba Inu.
But thankfully, a texter has told us what the truth is, that dogs are a lot more like you than you realize.
Yeah. Yeah. They're my people.
Yeah.
All right, well, I think, as you know, we're very excited for today because today is opening day. I think when you think about things in life, the one thing that's always exciting is opening day. It's like hope springs eternal for any baseball fan. Every team is the same. Every team looks excited. They've just come back from the greatest vacation ever, even though it's spring training.
Right.
I mean, they've been down either in Arizona or Florida. And tonight is the night where now it's for reals. They go back to their job.
And for once, we get to have like optimism about a team that potentially is going to be good, as opposed to in the past where it's just blind optimism.
And we are going to talk to our buddy. We've done this. We have made good on our promise as we have repaired our relationship with Ryan Roland Smith, because he felt like we never liked him because we never talked to him. But you know what? We've done. I think we've done a great job, haven't we, Steve?
Oh, dude, I think we're the best.
Yeah, Mariners and the Guardians from Cleveland tonight, opening night, opening day, and all over baseball. And yes, Ryan Roland Smith, the current Root Sports analyst, former pitcher for your Mariners, he'll be with us. We'll talk about what's so exciting about these M's at 7:17 on The Rock.
BJ and Migs, mornings on The Rock, 99.9 KISW.
Give dads and grads the gift of relaxation with Hand and Stone Massage and Facial Spa. Dads and Grads Season Ticket to Relax offers $30 off a massage or facial gift card or $70 off a massage and facial gift package. With 8 Seattle area locations, it's easy to find the one nearest you or explore exclusive online gift card sales. Let Hand and Stone help dads and grads restore, relax, and reset. Restrictions apply. See spa for more details.
You diet, you work out, and still there's that one stubborn spot. Hey, it's Jason. I just went after my stubborn fat by doing Cool Sculpting at Terene Dermatology, Minnesota's top Cool Sculpting provider. Dr. Terene is my dermatologist. We froze my fat, and those fat cells are gone for good. FDA approved. No pain, no downtime. Ranked top doctor 8 years in a row. Trust the experts at Terene Dermatology. Call today, 651-633-6883, and say goodbye to stubborn fat.
What you watch depends on what kind of mood you're in. Sometimes you're craving comedies like Friends or South Park, and sometimes you're more into dramas like HBO's Succession and House of the Dragon. There's also cooking shows like Chopped and Beat Bobby Flay, and even movies like The Lord of the Rings and Shazam Fury of the Gods. Well, Max is the streaming destination that has the best of entertainment for whatever mood you're in anytime. And plans start at as little as $9.99 a month. Max, the one to watch. Subscription required. Visit max.com.
My name is Erica Olivares. I feel really honored to be a Pima Medical student. Pima Medical to me is not just a school, it's a family, it's a forever connection. I definitely doubted myself, but I've gained a lot of confidence here. I feel like we are the best of the best.
Learn hands-on medical skills and life skills to start your healthcare career with confidence.
You can do this too. Start now at pmi.edu.
99.9 KISW, The Rock of Seattle.
BJ, very excited to have our guest on the show, especially with today being opening day, the start of the Mariners' quest to win their first ever World Series. Please welcome to the show the man, the myth, the legend, our good friend Ryan Roland Smith.
There he is.
What's up, fellas?
There he is from the Ryan Roland Smith compound, where there is nothing but palm trees and beverages.
Dude, Ryan's been on a world tour, man, because he went for the World Baseball Classic and then spring training. You've been going everywhere, man.
Look at you, WBC boy, and you never even once called me and said, hey, would you like to come along and watch the WBC? I thought we were something to each other. I thought we had something.
Well, I thought so too, but hey, last time we spoke, the Mariners had just lost in the playoffs, and we were talking about Blink-182 tickets or something, and I was dropping hints, I was like, well, hey, you know, like, look, concert tickets, there's only really one place I need to go to get them, and you guys just weren't picking them up at all.
Here I am
back at the Roland Smith compound. With
right.
Vegemite, palm trees. Here I am.
Yeah.
The last time you guys
call
me.
Ryan, if you want to go to Blink-182, once we figure out what's going on around here, you know we got you taken care of.
Yeah, we'll meet in the pit, Ryan.
Right now, we're hoping we get to go to Blink-182. But hell yeah, man. Of course. You got to come party with us.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. You know what? We definitely dropped the ball on that one. Yeah. Ryan, it is always good talking to you. And boy, especially, I feel so good about this team. Steve, I think for real this year, Steve always just thinks the Mariners are going to win the World Series. But I think
one of these times I'm going to be right.
He feels like it. And Ryan, are we crazy or is there a good? And I know you work for Root Sports. And of course, you know, they don't want you to say horrible things. But you're always a guy that I believe at least tells as much of the truth as you can without really, you know, ticking off the staff. But are we crazy for thinking the Mariners really have a shot this year?
No, I think that you know, look, and by the way, I get pretty honest regardless of who I'm talking to, and I'll be straight up with you guys. But, you know, there were some times during the winter where I was a little frustrated they didn't go out and make certain moves. But once you get to spring training, you sort of look around and say, well, if they did make moves, they did bring guys in. You know, I'm talking about, you know, like an extra you know, starting pitcher or bringing in, you know, someone for left field. And when you get to spring training, all of a sudden you look around at this team, you're like, okay, they are young. But in a good way. What I mean by that is the core of this team have already been through enough. Last year, they struggled. They had their struggles last year. They've been to the playoffs. They've got George Kirby, who is, in my opinion, is going to be going for, you know, he's going to be in the Cy Young conversation.
Wow, that's
season,
wow.
In his sophomore year.
Wow.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. He's a stud, man. You watch him up close and you see what he's done this winter and all the reports coming into what he's looking like in spring training. It is exciting. So I think that if...
Yeah, and then, by the way, you're a former major league pitcher. So, you know, to me, that carries so much weight when a guy like you who has been out there and has done it tells me you think this guy's a Cy Young candidate. That means a lot to me.
Yeah, and listen, man, I'm very honest with pitchers. And, like, someone asked me back in the day when I got done playing, someone said, oh, would you ever like to get into scouting? I said, I'd be a terrible scout because I wouldn't sign anyone. No one would be good enough. You know what I mean? That's how it feels like. So I'm very critical on some of these pitches. But George Kirby and even Logan Gilbert, man, I think both these guys are just going to have absolute breakout years. So they're in such a good spot. If there's ever a time to jump, if you're obviously, I know a lot of your listeners may be on the fence about, you know, watching their baseball team. But this is the time. If you're a bandwagon fan, this is the time to get on because they're young and they're good. They've been through it before. I just think this is a really good time, not just for this year, but for the next half a decade coming up, for sure.
And we're talking to Ryan Roland-Smith, by the way. You can catch Ryan doing a lot of analysts, and every once in a while you'll catch him calling the game, too, on Root Sports, which is where you can watch opening night tonight. The Mariners, the Guardians at T-Mobile Park. If you can't go, then watch it on Root Sports at 7 o'clock. And very, very excited for this season, man.
Ryan, we got to ask you. I mean, I think it's the one thing a lot of Mariners fans are hoping that we're going to see a change in the ways for Jared Kelenic. What do you think? I know he had a great spring training, but do you think that this is going to be a season where we could see some of those high hopes that everyone had last year for him?
I hope so, man. I think that, you know, look, spring training doesn't tell you a whole lot. Anyone can go down and just put up numbers because it's this environment where you still feel like you're in the off season. It's just those Peoria Sport Complex games where the sun's out and you've got these, you know, workouts. You're still in that sort of off-season mode. And we all know the minute April rolls around, there's a little bit of that coolness in the air. Yeah. And the lights come on and your walk-up song comes on. People are pitching you differently. They're actually sequencing you a little bit differently. They're going off a scouting report as opposed to just, you know, throwing up pitches. Everything changes. So I can answer that question with Jared Kelenic. I would say, In the middle of May, if you're looking at a guy who, and I'm not talking about numbers so much, but I'm talking about good at-bats, not swinging at bad pitches, not getting frustrated, and just looks comfortable and looks like he's enjoying being a major leaguer. I've said this about Jared Kelenic all the time. He just needs to, he is so good. He's such a good athlete. He just needs to be one of these bros and just enjoy being a major leaguer. You know what I mean? Stop over-processing everything. So I think that this first month's going to tell us a lot, I really do believe. But I did see him yesterday. They had a workout yesterday, and he did look different. Like, psychologically, there's something different there with him. I think he looks a little bit more comfortable. But, man, he is so talented, so ridiculously talented. If he can just figure it out and just chill out upstairs a little bit, you know, in between the years, and just enjoy the process of being cliche as that sounds, God, man, he could be that factor that this team...
And that's all I have to say about that.
We just lost him.
We lost Ryan Roland-Smith. Wow, just like that. What do we have him on? Was that just a phone? We just lost him on the phone?
Just the phone.
All right, try to get him back.
That was a weird...
Yeah, it went dong. Right, you know what? You know our digital phone line makes all these weird sounds and stuff? Yeah.
What if that's just like his tactic? He hits a button that makes that sound and he just dips out.
He's like, I'm sick of
talking about Jared Kelenic.
I have said enough.
This guy.
We're going to try to get Ryan Roland-Smith back on. You can tweet him at -18. Great pitcher for the Mariners. If you didn't know, really enjoyed him and has been a good friend of the show. And I definitely want to ask him about what he said, psychology. Because, Steve, you know, because you've played sports. You do a lot of stuff. When you are in your own head thinking that, oh, my God, this sport is against me or whatever reason, it does make a difference. And what I want to ask him is, I think that this year when they've changed the shifts, mm-hmm. which means if you're a pitcher, yeah, I think it's going to be harder for you to do your job. But if you're a batter, you might think in your brain it's going to be easier for you to do your job, which I'm thinking a guy like Jared Kelnick, maybe that psychology will actually have him go, you know what, I feel better. I feel better going up to the plate.
Because he's doing great in spring. Like you said, spring training is a whole different. Even minor league ball, the guy seems to be doing great as well. So it'd be nice to see him be able to take some of that kind of confidence and translate it to actually with the Mariners.
So we got him back?
Yes.
So, Hyphen, what we were talking about was the psychology of it all. The shift changing meaning that now all the players have to say, the shortstop and the third baseman have to stay on their side of second base, and same thing for second base and first base, and you no longer can have people in the outfield except outfielders. That psychology, which we talked about, I'm thinking would make a batter think, I have a better chance of getting on base, and the pitcher now has to it's going to be a little tougher for me doing my job. Do you think that's a sweeping generalization that makes sense with this new shift change?
Yeah, I think that there's going to be way more offense this year. I mean, I'm sure you've talked about the pitch clock, already. There's 15 seconds that rushes pitches as well. You've got, the shift change in regards to, you can't just, heat map. And what I mean by that is if you go to Jared Kelnick, for example, coming up and he's hitting 85% of the balls on the ground into right side of the infield. You can't do that anymore. So it opens up the field so much. They've done so much data on this in the minor leagues, and batting average has gone way up. So if you're a kid like Jared Kelnick, you shouldn't really be thinking about it. I think for him, he should be just thinking about some of the things I've talked about. I don't know when my mouth drowned out the power of this phone. Nah. But I think that if he can just think about some of the simple things, offensively, man, he can just, again, cliche as it sounds, as typical as it sounds, but if he can just relax, enjoy himself being a major league player. I got caught up in that, just trying to over-process too much and just not letting just talent take over. But I think he's going to be okay. He's too talented, I still feel like, to miss.
We're talking to Ryan Roland-Smith. The Washington Post has done an article about the San Diego Padres, Ryan, and this definitely, I think, is something that Mariner fans can think about, feel, and it all is based to me on this meme that I've seen, and that is, the Padres are a small market team that has spent big money, which is not what you usually see. Conversely, what do we see with this meme? Ken Griffey Jr. is the fourth highest paid player this year on the Cincinnati Reds. Even though he hasn't played baseball for a decade, he's still collecting a salary, and the Reds have him as their fourth highest paid player because they're also a small market team. Yet the Padres are breaking that mold, and the Washington Post thinks that's very interesting. And I'm wondering, what do you think? I mean, this is the thing with baseball, is that money does make a difference, where in other sports there are salary caps, and so you can't just go out and have, every great player. But the Padres, for a team their size, that's what they're doing, and it's the great experiment, because most teams that size, like the Mariners, can't do that. Do you think that is a strategy that can work, or you think it might bite them in the butt?
Well, I think that, okay, so it's super risky what they're doing, because you're investing in, as we all know, investing in a human being, doesn't matter if it's sport or not, and when you guarantee that you're going to pay them for 5+ years, people change, right? And again, physically, obviously, but psychologically too. We've talked about that already. So when you look at these teams like the Padres who just go out and go crazy and spend money, you better have some of these little things. You better have good, besides all spending the money, you better be able to still draft and develop players. You still better know these players, how they are going to react in 2 to 3 years from now. Because, man, if the San Diego Padres come out and they do not make it to the World Series, man, it is a bust. And yeah, people can feel it when you spend that much money. Now, if you're a fan, you love it. But when you look at the last 10 years, the teams who have had all World Series runs, been in the playoffs a ton, they're teams that build from within. And what I mean by that is they draft and develop players. They have young cores of players they come up together, they go through some of these processes, like you're seeing with the Mariners, and that, honestly, put the money aside, that's how you make it, that's how you make a run at this thing. Not just for a year, but for 5, 6, that's how you sustain, you know, some of these runs. I hate to use them as an example, but the Houston Astros are a classic example of that. They're a mid-market team as well. You get that core of players that you draft and develop, and then you sprinkle on some of the big money signings on top of it. And the Mariners, look, they're in a position now that if you get to that draft, the trade deadline, that you can do that. They will add mid-year. If they're in a good spot, they've got these really good young core of players, and you can add. Now, if you're the Cincinnati Reds, it's very obvious that if you don't have that foundation of drafting talent, developing, kind of like the Seahawks did for years and years and years as well. But if you don't have that, if you're not good at doing that, it's not about you spending money. It's about you finding new people inside your front office to do it. And that they haven't done that. So they're not in a position to even spend money. And that's why you see, you know, Ken Griffey Jr., who hasn't played in, you know, however long, is still getting deferred money because, you know, that's how he kind of structures his contract. So baseball's funny like that, man. You really have to be good. Initially, first of all, you have to be able to develop players in your minor league system. Then you add players with the money side of things on top of that.
So, I think since you're a pitcher, and I'm gonna just piggyback on that a little bit, because one of the big signings the Padres did was Xander Bogaerts, who is not a great defensive shortstop. And this was what really surprised me, is the Padres are going all in with this big money strategy when the shift change is happening. And I look at you as a pitcher and say, who would you rather have behind you at shortstop, Xander Bogaerts or J.P. Crawford? I am taking J.P. Crawford every day of the week. I don't care if J.P. never gets a hit. As a pitcher, I want that dude behind me, not a guy who's kind of sketchy at the shortstop position, which everybody knows Xander is. He's a great hitter, not a great defender. So when he's at his best. Well, I would rather have JP behind me, and I think every pitcher would.
Well, a couple things. First of all, Xander Bogaerts, when they signed him, they wanted to go big at the shortstop position. Fernando Tatis, they wanted to move him to the outfield. And at that point, they were out on some of the other shortstops, too. They went in hard to trade Turner and couldn't get him. So it's one of those things, like, all right, who's left in these big money shortstops? And it was Xander Bogaerts. Now, Xander Bogaerts, I played with him at the Red Sox. Great dude. He was at the World Baseball Classic in Taiwan, where I was. Great dude. It was so good to see him again. And just as from a teammate standpoint, as an offensive player, he is so good for a team. He really is. Now, J.P. Crawford, on the other hand, J.P. last year had one of the worst defensive years he's ever had. He came off a Gold Glove year, and then all of a sudden last year, defensively, he was struggling. The reason for that is because he was carrying around injuries. So, if anyone out there who talks about, oh, he's shortstop, took a dive, well, you kind of have to think about this. Here's a guy that just would not get off the field. He refused to get off and deal with some of the little niggly things he had going on lower body, right? And so you love that. But at the same time, I think JP, if he can stay healthy, you will get that defense. And the Mariners, you look at this rotation their pitching may have and their defense behind it, that's going to be that as a team, man, that's going to be that foundation for them. But JP, he's got to stay healthy because, man, you mentioned it, when he is at his best, he's a Gold Glove shortstop, and he's just got that energy for a team that the offense, you can take a little bit of the offense and put him down the bottom of the lineup, but you want to have him out there every single day.
I was just reading, it's crazy to see how people are talking already about Julio Rodriguez potentially being a favorite for MVP in his second season. It's like that's an exciting thing to see what he's going to do this year. And I don't know if you read his Players Tribune article that he put out, or his contribution to the Players Tribune, where it's all about how much he loves being in Seattle, how a big part of why he wants to stay here forever is that the team lets him just be him. And my favorite part also is that whenever he sees a space needle, it makes him think about the Jetsons as a kid. And that's another part of why he loves being in Seattle. But it was so great. I was like reading the article. I think he said, every time I'm at the ballpark, every time I'm walking around the city, every time I look at the space needle and remember the Jetsons cartoons I used to watch on the living room floor, I'm reminded about how happy I am here. Man, how fired up are you about seeing Julio Rodriguez this year?
Well, first of all, I will say with Julio, it's one of these things, if he says, makes a Jetsons comment, because I feel like I made the exact same comment, everyone's like, yeah, no one cares, dude. No one knows who you are, shut up. Yeah, I mean, if he says it, man, all of a sudden everyone's like, oh, wow, it's Julio, Jetsons. That's cool as that. But no, I mean, listen, he, if there's
if there's one player, that can absorb all this attention and absorb the fact that Major League Baseball is literally pinning him to be the face of the league, and I'm not exaggerating.
Yeah,
they are pushing, you know, from a marketing standpoint, to have the guy who's wearing a Seattle Mariners uniform to be the face of Major League Baseball. Young, energy, like, yeah, you know, fast moving, all these things they want the game to be with these new rule changes and everything else. So it's exciting. Another reason why, if you're just on the fence about, you know, watching the Mariners, man, this is the year to do it, I feel like. Because we have literally the best young player. And there is no exaggeration for that MVP conversation at the end of the year. He's going to put up numbers. Man, he, like I said, he just has that thing about him that not many players do, where they can just take on everything that comes his way and just absorb it, not deflect it. You know, you see these players, they try and deflect it, or they push it away, or they try and, you know, get, fall into their little... They kind of become a little bit reclusive. No, he loves it. He'll just stand out the front and say, yep, who's next? Who wants to talk to me? It's awesome, man. And you watching him yesterday with fans, too. Mm-hmm. It is special. There is a different vibe around him, even in March already.
It reminds me of Russell Wilson and what he did for the Seahawks and all those, you know, all those great Seahawk players that all of a sudden got attention for a team in the Pacific Northwest, which was kind of ignored in football. And I'm feeling that same vibe for what the Mariners, because of what J-Rod's doing.
Yeah, well, I think I hate to compare because everyone does it and it's not fair either. But the Griffey Julio comparisons,
yeah,
not just numbers, but just kind of that overall presence. I think that that's a fun comparison.
Sure,
yeah,
is.
Sometimes we talk about, oh, hey, look at the numbers as a rookie. Look at the second year numbers. What did they have to be like Griffey and all this kind of stuff? And that's just silly. They both played in different eras, so it's kind of hard to do. But in regards to just all that presence when he's around, it's very similar to everything that was talked about with Griffey, for sure.
Ryan Roland Smith, you can catch him on Roots Sports. You can tweet him at @-18. Ryan, it is always awesome to talk baseball with you, and I hope we have lots of opportunity because of the fact the Mariners are killing it. And we'll try to see about those tickets, Steve. Right?
Oh yeah, definitely. The request has been put in.
That's yeah.
Because yeah, I appreciate it, guys.
Yeah, but I tweeted at Tom DeLong. I'm just waiting to hear back from him. And you know, now he's back in the band. He's a little busy, but you know, I figure he'll get back to me soon.
We'll see what we can do. All right, Ryan, thanks, bro. It's always great talking to you. And go Mariners, man. I'm excited for this season.
Yeah, me too. Appreciate it, guys. Thanks a lot.
All right, take it easy. I know we were calling him. I think he's in town. It felt like we were calling him overseas.
We were using a new technology, which is a string and a can.
Oh, that's why it was a few bit of a
seconds
delay.
It was like a Skype call.
It really was.
I know.
Yeah, it was so bizarre, yeah. For a minute, I thought, I was like, you know what, maybe he doesn't like anything I'm saying.
Or he's just a very profound man that likes to think before he answers. Not everyone's quick. Sometimes he wants to, you know, flesh out his thoughts before he says, it was nice being on the show.
Somebody thinks before they speak. I don't know what that concept means.
Yeah, none of us do.
Anyway, Root Sports tonight. Mariners, if you can't go to the ballpark tonight because it's sold out, but who knows, secondary, third, tertiary, whatever. But dude, Root Sports has the game for
BJ,
you.
Look, I'm not even a fan of reading, and I read this thing. And this player
is
an article by Julio Rodriguez. I retweeted it. It's called Seattle Forever. And it is just a love letter to Seattle.
Oh,
it talks about his struggles at the beginning of last year, but it also talks about how, like, the team always believed in him and let him be him. And it talks about his relationship with Ichiro and other players and just how much he loves being in Seattle, and why a big part of why he wanted to sign a long-term deal with this team was that he could stay in Seattle.
Yeah, it's
really, and then hearing Ryan talk about how the league is looking at him as the face of the league, and it's a guy in our own backyard. That's pretty freaking cool.
You're right, dude. You're right. It's very, very awesome, and that's exciting. That, you know, here we are, Seattle. We are we're being mentioned in sports again, and now it's baseball, which of course is my favorite sport. Gotta love that.
And it looks like he was in the back of Chris Steakhouse when he was figuring out all this stuff about staying in Seattle. So.
Oh, really? Back of Ruth? Well, that's a great place to go. Ruth's Chris is.
Yeah.
I mean, make a decision while you're having a nice steak.
It's very hard to say Ruth's Chris.
I know, I hate it.
Yeah, sorry. Well, everybody just says Ruth Chris. They don't even do the S anymore.
Well, I feel like I owe it to them to say it. Right?
Well, you owe it to me just because it's so funny to hear you try to say Ruth's.
Ruth Chris.
That you owe it to all of us to continue to try to say it that way. Someone gave a waitress a brand new car
as a tip.
In case you were riding an elephant.
Sorry, Danny. Is that on me? Is that Ryan Rollinsmith's fault?
That was all his fault.
Yeah. Well, anyway, despite this generous gift, people on the internet are actually pissed about this. So a guy gives a car to a person as a tip, and people are, hard to believe, people on the internet are pissed.
Shocking.
All right. I will tell you all about this after, well, this guy named Taz tells you some stuff.
Today's podcast was brought to you by Travis Gagne, bankruptcy attorney. He's here right now and has agreed to answer more of your questions about bankruptcy. Here's another listener question. How do I rebuild my credit after filing bankruptcy?
You rebuild it, you know, one creditor at a time by making your payments on time to on your rent or your mortgage, by continuing to make car payments on a car that you keep during your case. You can also, as I said, you can almost always get a credit card almost immediately after filing bankruptcy. Sometimes it's a secured card and it'll almost always have a really high interest rate on it, but you can get a small balance credit card and, you know, charge a tank of gas or a dinner once a month on that and make the payment, pay it off every month, and that'll help you build a credit history one creditor at a time and will help you rebuild your credit over time.
Thanks, Travis. If you have more questions about bankruptcy, you can reach out to Travis anytime at ChooseTheRightChapter.com. That's ChooseTheRightChapter.com. Thanks for listening.
T-Mobile's network can help keep you connected to all your favorite podcasts when you're out and about. Whether you're an early bird looking to dive into a daily news podcast or a night owl who wants to catch up on the latest reality TV drama, T-Mobile will keep you connected on their strong and reliable network. T-Mobile covers more highway miles with 5G than anyone. So if you need great coverage, especially when you're on the go, check out T-Mobile. Find out more at T-Mobile.com/CY. That's SEEWHY.
If you need rehab after surgery, help at home, or if you need a place to enjoy the best years of your life after 60, Carriage is here for you. Carriage is a family-owned healthcare and senior living company that puts people first. Let us provide you with short-term, post-acute rehabilitation at one of our skilled nursing facilities in Bellevue and Renton. Expert in-home care and support to clients throughout Washington. Or enjoy a vibrant retirement in elegant, amenity-rich surroundings in Washington and California. Learn more at Carriage.com.
High schoolers are busy, but no one's too busy to help fight blood cancer. The Leukemia and Lymphoma Society is looking for our next Student Visionaries of the Year. With a little initiative, chosen students can change the lives of real patients and help be a part of the last generation to see blood cancer. Learn more about our program and how to nominate a young visionary in your community at lls.org/student visionaries. That's lls.org/student visionaries.
I was scared the night you overdosed, but I was prepared. I brought naloxone with me, and I knew how to use it. I held your hand tight when you woke up, because I wanted you to feel safe. Your life is worth saving, friend, and I would save it again if I had to.
Naloxone can reverse an opioid or fentanyl overdose. Carry it with you. For more info, go to preventoverdosewa.org. A message from the Washington State Department of Health.
Have you been in an accident that wasn't your fault? Feeling overwhelmed and unsure what to do next? Look no further. The personal injury attorneys at Phillips Law Firm are here to help. Phillips Law Firm understands that accidents can turn your life upside down. That's why they're dedicated to fighting for the compensation you deserve and to making the process as stress-free as possible. Don't wait any longer. Call now, 1-800-JUSTICE, or visit justiceforyou.com.
Whether you love true crime or comedies, celebrity interviews, news, or even motivational speakers, you call the shots on what's in your podcast queue, right? And guess what? Now you can call the shots on your auto insurance, too. Enter the Name Your Price tool from Progressive. The Name Your Price tool puts you in charge of your auto insurance by working just the way it sounds. You tell Progressive how much you want to pay for car insurance, then they'll show you a variety of coverages that fit within your budget, giving you options. Now that's something you'll want to press play on. It's easy to start a quote, and you'll be able to choose the best option for you fast. It's just one of the many ways you can save with Progressive Insurance. Quote today at Progressive.com to try the Name Your Price tool for yourself and join the over 29 million drivers who trust Progressive. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law.
Hey, this is BJ. Thanks for listening to our show's podcast. If you're a fan of all things geeky, you should check out my other podcast, BJ Shea's Geek Nation. We have new episodes every day, and you can check it out at bjgeeknation.com.
Your driver's license is important so you can get back and forth to work, get your kids to school, and back and forth to daycare. If your license has been suspended because you can't pay your tickets, you can't do any of those things. Let's talk about Chapter 13 bankruptcy. You may have heard that tickets cannot be discharged, but they can be dealt with in a Chapter 13 case. Why not come in for a free consultation? The chapter you choose will make all the difference to your getting back, legally, on the road. Let's design a plan to pay off your tickets and restore your license immediately. I'm attorney Travis Gagne. Please contact me today at ChooseTheRightChapter.com. That's ChooseTheRightChapter.com.
99.9 KISW, the Rock of Seattle. All right, this Mr. Beast dude on YouTube, man, I mean, he is making a name for himself. And well-deserved.
Pays for people to get their vision back, hooks people up with money.
How old is he, like 10? I mean, the guy, I mean, at such a young age.
He's like 17 now.
Yeah, I mean, really, at such a young age that he has created what he's created for himself is just, to me, it's a great, inspiring story how he's become a gigantic celebrity, really making his own money, doing his own thing, and then doing some incredible things for people with his money.
He's 24 years old. He has admittedly said that he's an obsessed fan of YouTube, and that's why this all started. Like, he just wanted to become a YouTube star, and it kind of snowballed, and then he started realizing, oh, I'm doing all these things that are kind of feel-good stories. I'm hooking people up, yeah, to get my YouTube views and get all my subscriptions up, but I'm also doing good things, and I think it created a good monster for him in a sense that he's constantly doing feel-good stories, yeah, to get all the likes and get the subscriptions and the views, but he's hooking people up with, like, life-changing stuff.
And I don't know generationally, and you know me, I love to examine the generations. I think he's a Zoomer. At 24 years old, is he Generation Z? I pretty much think he is. And he, to me, typifies success in the media world for Generation Z. He's got all this fame and is a and he leads with his heart.
And he gives away a ton of money over
yeah.
And sometimes he says he's even like, he has to wait for sponsors to help pay for whatever it is because he spent all his money
yeah.
for these elaborate, like buying an island or like these things are ridiculous, but he's just having the most fun with his money and doing good stuff. And apparently he has 139 million subscribers, which is the most followed YouTuber, individual YouTuber in the world.
Yeah, and if you're a business person or if you're in the media, this is the guy to watch. This is the person to watch as far as what do I got to do to be successful, especially to appeal to a younger audience? You know, how can I be great for them? Everything he does is how you do it. I'm like, you can't do it better than this guy's doing it.
And the guy once challenged Dwayne The Rock Johnson to a game of rock, paper, scissors for $100,000.
Did that happen?
I think it did, yeah.
Well, I mean, you know what? I mean, yep. I can't. Oh, look at that. Good for, see, the kid's brilliant because The Rock is the king of self-promotion for his generation, no doubt about it, and he uses social media very well. I hate to give him credit.
And in the end, they both donated $100,000 to the Make-A-Wish Foundation.
I'm going to tell you.
So here we are talking about how great Mr. Beast is, but I'd like to hear some awesome stuff about The Rock.
Not going
to
happen.
Please, son of a bitch.
Yes, sir. Especially with this story, because I think you would think I would be totally pissed off about this story.
Okay.
Because it's reminiscent of The Rock. But is a slight difference. And this is what we're going to tell you. This is, again, first of all, you got miserable people on the internet. You would think that would be me.
Yes.
Because I am a miserable person, and once in a while I go on the internet. But so Mr. Beast helps out this waitress. She'd been going back and forth to work without a vehicle for months. So what did he do? He tipped her a new car. Well, he tipped her a car. And here's that moment that Amy, the waitress, received this car as a tip.
What's the biggest tip you've ever gotten?
Like $50.
$50?
Yeah.
Has anyone ever tipped a car?
This is a car key. This is not a car.
Do you want to see it? It's outside. Well, let's go. Right over here, you'll see your brand new car.
Are you serious?
Yes.
Oh, wow. I wasn't expecting you to cry.
I mean, this isn't real.
No, it is real. Just hit the unlock button. See if it makes noise.
I was literally late to work today because you were so hard. I'm like in such shock right now. I don't even know how to drive.
Enjoy the car.
Thank you so much.
So, I mean, come on. That is a cool thing to do. Now, people are pissed at Mr. Beast, and there's a reason. What you don't see, unless you go to the video, which you can watch on the BJ and Migs page of KISW.com, once you see the video, you can see why people are pissed, because the car that Mr. Beast gave her is wrapped with a logo for his own food line, Mr. Beast's Feastables.
Right.
And so, yeah.
And they got, like, different snacks and different, like, you know.
Yeah.
Like a peanut butter chocolate thing called D's Nuts.
It is a great. I love that. I want to get that.
It's an explosion of peanut butter flavor.
And so a lot of folks are going, you jerk, you should have just given her a car. You should.
That's
didn't
the
have,
funny
there shouldn't
part.
Be a walking advertisement or a riding advertisement
so
for her.
Like, so basically she has to do promotion for his company by driving the car. Another person's like, is he going to cover the tax on that as well? And like, maybe he is. We don't know. And who knows what, like, I don't know if he's like, hey, you need to keep the wrap on the car. He might have like done that for the video purposes. And then,
all right.
Like, and even so, I would drive a Feastables car if it was free. I don't give a crap. Like, she had no car.
Let's just talk about what it would cost for that car. Okay, like if somebody said to you, if you want to buy a new car for, let's say, $35,000, $40,000, the tax on that car would be whatever the tax is, 5%, 6%, 7%, I don't know.
Right.
But what if somebody told you you could get a car just for the cost of the tax of a car? Like if you walked into a dealer and they
sign me up.
Exactly. So for when people use that as a thing, that girl can't get a better deal for a car than what the tax would be, and that's all she'd have to pay.
She's not forced to keep it. I mean, she could do whatever she wants.
She can sell it if she needs to.
She could just say, no, honestly, I just don't want to deal with the burden of all that. Like, why are we mad at him? He gave her a car. Like, I'm sorry, like, when's the last time the people who are complaining gave anybody a car?
And
if you haven't, shut the F up.
And you know me, I get mad at The Rock because I do what because The Rock does what he does. But in this particular instance, he's basically giving somebody the opportunity to work for that vehicle, because all she has to do is just let it look the way it looks and she gets a free car.
And honestly, it's not like obnoxious. It just says Feastables on the side. It's got kind of a cool little design on it. And apparently it's a $21,000 car. It's a Toyota sedan and it looks nice. And again, like, she doesn't want the damn wrap on it. Take it off.
Yeah. I mean, I don't know if that's a deal where she has to keep it on for a certain amount of time. I have no idea.
I would take that in a heart. Dude, I thought about that when I was younger and broke, when I was trying to get a new car. And there was a thing around town, like, that, hey, you get this car, but you have to have a giant wrap on it. Like, but it was like, you know, you had to get picked for it. I wanted to do it so bad. I didn't care what the company was. It could have been a tampon company. I wouldn't give a crap.
I was about to ask, would you be cool with a tampon company? Because when I was a middle school, high school, there was a show on MTV called, like, Undressed or something. Yeah. And one guy's like, I'm going to get this cool car. It's just going to have a logo on it. It'll be fine. But I get to drive this sweet car. And it was a tampon car. And all the ladies got mad at him for not having free tampons to give away.
Well, he should have had that. That would be a good way. Joe, think about that maybe for your new way of meeting.
Oh, that's a pickup line.
Yeah.
Here's some free tampons.
Would you like a tampon, lady?
Keep that one in the back pocket.
Yeah. But it's not a bad idea.
But this isn't like, it's not obnoxious. It's not like a bright purple giant logos on it. And Feastables are delicious from what I hear. So
I have not had any. So if you want to get some, or, you know, if somebody, I think
would
I have
you
to
like
order
these nuts.
I'll take some D's nuts.
Yeah.
Yeah, you would think I'd be upset at this kid.
Why, though?
Well, because I'm upset at The Rock.
Okay.
But, I mean, it's more just The Rock. It's, you know, and also because I know it pisses you off, so that's even more why I'm upset. In reality, I have no reason to be upset at The Rock. The guy has done an amazing job with his life, and I think Mr. Beast, the same thing. At 24 years old, here's the people that are upset with him, Steve. They're envious as all hell at what he's done.
And they would take a free car in a heartbeat if he gave it to them.
And that's why I bring generations into it. If you're Gen X, if you're baby boomer, hell, even if you're an old millennial, you look at what Mr. Beast has done. He has manipulated a system that you don't even know how it works. And he's made a ton of money doing it. And he's also, for the most part, seeming like a nice guy on that system, which also pisses you off. And because that's not the way we were raised to do business. We were raised, when it comes to business, being a nice guy, you finish last. And Mr. Beast is showing you that you can actually finish pretty high being a nice guy. And people like me, boomers and some Gen Xers are probably going, no, nice guys always finish last. He can't be a nice guy. And I love that he's breaking that mold, man.
I think it's fun. If I had all that kind of money, I think it'd be a blast to be able to just like do these random things, like feel good stories like that. I love the part where he's like, here's your tip. And she's like, it's a key for a car, but is there a car attached to this? Which I thought was a really funny moment. Like,
good for her.
Thanks for giving me a key fob, but what am I going to do with this? He's like, no, there's a car attached to it.
And if you look at Mr. Beast in the video, he just looks like a rando. That's what I also like about him. He just, like, if he can incognito go anywhere, as popular as he is, I would imagine that the average person as he walks in has no idea who he is, even though he's super popular.
We have talked about him several times. If he was walking around in the kitchen right now, I'd just be thinking like he's here to work on our coffee machine.
Agreed.
And I've seen pictures of him. He's very unassuming. I would just be like, hey, nice to meet you. Are you fixing our coffee machine? Is it going to taste good now? Cool.
That's why Seattle should adopt him, because he looks like he fit right in with the city. Because how many luminary celebrities and successful people do we have that look like Mr. Beast? Just rando guys. Never know.
No, I don't want this attention whore in our city.
Oh, damn. Okay.
I'm kidding.
Like I said, some Gen Xers might be jealous.
He needs to bring me some of them D's nuts.
Oh, is that what he needs to do?
They're sold out right now.
Yeah, they are sold out.
Whoa, I guess it's working.
Yeah.
It's all working.
Yeah, his website. He also does like the pop-up restaurants isn't he have like the Beast Burger?
Yep.
Oh, really?
And I hear that's super popular. I think he goes to like Red Robin. I think it's like one of those those pop-up kitchens or whatever they call them.
So here's what I would like to say, as a free tip for our company. You know what, Steve? I'm going to give a free tip for our company.
You know what? You shouldn't. You should charge them.
I think I will charge them, because we just have one of the high-ranking officials in our company.
Yeah.
Somebody from our company, I don't care who it is, should make a deal with Mr. Beast and have him be a prominent face in our company. He is the future of entertainment, and the guy is amazing.
He's got time for us. He's like, I'm rich as all hell.
Unless we can be a vehicle for him to do good stuff like he likes to do, which we can be. We do have that kind of reach. We have an amazing reach, and what a great partnership that would be.
And if I'm Mr. Beast, I'm like, I have 159 million subscribers.
That's true.
My reach is pretty good there, BJ. Yeah.
I agree, but
I don't need to sign no deals.
Here's the thing that he doesn't have, though.
Man that follows my own. He doesn't
have the reach. We have reach that's different reach, though, in a lot of our places. So I think we make a great team.
We need to say, we're in cahoots with YouTube. Because I remember hearing in an interview, some people were like, I think it was the Joe Rogan interview that he did. It was really good. He just comes up as a real likable guy. And he's like, you could probably make more money just creating your own website and putting your videos there, because he has to give YouTube a cut.
Yeah.
And he's like, but I like being on YouTube. And I thought that was I'm paraphrasing it, but it was the most innocent thing ever. He's like, I'm such a fan of YouTube. Yeah, I can make more money without them, but I love the reach that YouTube has, and I just love being on YouTube, because he was obsessed with YouTube as a kid.
I will broker the deal if they need me to.
Oh, boy.
No,
what do you mean, no? I love this kid. What? How would I ruin this? I love what he does.
I'm not saying you would ruin it. I think he would, A, I don't think he would return your tweets, but.
Okay, that's why you got to have, he's got to recognize that we're at least a big company and we love what he does.
Right.
But here's what, what the secret is?
What's the secret?
Any young person, especially like him, you're talking generations removed, when an old person actually says, you are amazing, you impress me, when does that ever happen for a young person? Usually young people look at old people and old people tell them how stupid they are. I mean, that's usually the dynamic.
Well, that's why you have to compliment the dancers when you're at the strip clubs, BJ.
Sure. Also, Steve, there's a Mr. Beast Burger in Puyallup.
What?
Yep.
Where?
Order delivery.
Wait.
So it's one of the...
It's probably through the Red Robin.
The pop-up
there's
things.
A lot.
Yeah, there's a lot in Seattle.
Really?
But definitely one in Puyallup.
You can get a Mr. Beast Burger here?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh,
I think he has a plant-based one. Ooh. If I remember. I don't know.
All right. Well, listen, I know that's important for you.
It is.
But for me, I'm just happy they got a regular
one. Well, maybe when you have your conversation with him and you're like, hey, I'm the old guy telling you nice things, can you also recommend that he makes a plant-based burger?
Oh, now
burger
all
for
of
me?
A sudden, now you have invested.
Never mind.
Interest.
You already got one. I don't need your help.
Yeah, Impossible Burger is a bunch of them, actually.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, you've got the Beast style, the Chandler style, and the other styles.
See, I feel like,
I want the BJ style. Yeah, you should pitch your own BJ burger.
Listen, I'm not going to pitch anything. That he's a great guy, and I wish we could work with him to do great things for him. Is there any way? I just would go, you think we could be helpful, we'd love to work with you. That's my attitude.
Oh, so it's at Safeway and Ording has his bars. I bought these nuts last night.
Wait, so he's in supermarkets? Wow, he wasn't even on Shark Tank. How'd he get in all these places?
He's not working with
He doesn't
us.
Need anybody. He doesn't even need Shark
That's
Tank.
That's what I'm saying. So you don't go in like he needs you. You go in like we need you. Would you be willing to help us with your greatness? And can we help you be great in any way?
Okay.
Like giving stuff away. That's
tweet
how you
that.
Do it.
Just tweet him that. That's under 140 characters.
Yeah.
There's our mission statement.
Well, that's why I need
you. You don't need us. We need you.
If the company lets me be an official representative, they let me go, I represent Odyssey.
I'm positive they would.
Yeah. I feel like sometimes when I do stuff like that, then I get somebody calls me in the office and goes, well, you're not, don't do that ever again. don't say you were.
Negotiator.
That's me, baby.
You need a jingle.
All right, look, man, imagine this. Owen Wilson, you know that guy.
Never heard of him.
He had a lifetime all-access pass from the Rolling Stones given to him. Think about this. I mean, one of the biggest bands in the history of ever, and he had a lifetime all-access pass that was taken away from him. Owen Wilson lost the pass because of something that he did at one show. What did Owen Wilson do that got his lifetime pass revoked from the Stones? You'll find out at 8:17. He'll tell you on The Rock.
BJ and Migs, mornings on The Rock, 99.9 KISW.
Give dads and grads the gift of relaxation with Hand and Stone Massage and Facial Spa. Dads and Grads Season Ticket to Relax offers $30 off a massage or facial gift card or $70 off a massage and facial gift package. With 8 Seattle area locations, it's easy to find the one nearest you or explore exclusive online gift card sales. Let Hand and Stone help dads and grads restore, relax, and reset. Restrictions apply. See spa for more details.
You diet, you work out, and still there's that one stubborn spot. Hey, it's Jason. I just went after my stubborn fat by doing Cool Sculpting at Terreen Dermatology, Minnesota's top Cool Sculpting provider. Dr. Terreen is my dermatologist. We froze my fat, and those fat cells are gone for good. FDA approved. No pain, no downtime. Ranked top doctor 8 years in a row. Trust the experts at Terreen Dermatology. Call today, 651-633-6883, and say goodbye to stubborn fat.
What you watch depends on what kind of mood you're in. Sometimes you're craving comedies like Friends or South Park, and sometimes you're more into dramas like HBO's Succession and House of the Dragon. There's also cooking shows like Chopped and Beat Bobby Flay, and even movies like The Lord of the Rings and Shazam! Fury of the Gods. Well, Max is the streaming destination that has the best of entertainment for whatever mood you're in, anytime. And plans start at as little as $9.99 a month. Max, the one to watch. Subscription required. Visit max.com.
I was scared the night you overdosed, but I was prepared. I brought naloxone with me, and I knew how to use it. I held your hand tight when you woke up because I wanted you to feel safe. Your life is worth saving, friend, and I would save it again if I had to.
Naloxone can reverse an opioid or fentanyl overdose. Carry it with you. For more info, go to preventoverdosewa.org. A message from the Washington State Department of Health.
99.9 KISW, The Rock of Seattle. Owen Wilson had a lifetime all-access pass given to him by the Rolling Stones. That's actor Owen Wilson. You know him for a lot of stuff.
Wow.
Yeah.
That was him right there.
Yeah. And Rolling Stones, you know, they're kind of a popular band. Now, lifetime access, I mean, what do they tour every 10 years? So, I mean, I don't know how.
Do they hit the road quite a bit, though? I mean, if you're a super rich celebrity, when they go on tour, you can just travel around and go check them out.
If you do it like the Dead.
Yeah.
You know, yeah, sure. If you run around like it's a Dave Matthews band, sure, you would love a lifetime pass, go to every city.
I wonder how, like, what kind of relationship does he have that he was able to pull that off? Like,
he's been friends with them for a while, apparently.
I wonder which member. Like, is it like, is he like homies with, like, Mick or Keith, or is it just like he's Owen Wilson? And of course, they're excited to see him because he's, you know, they've probably seen him into movies and stuff.
Yeah, I wonder who he bro down with, because remember, the Stones are a lot older than him.
Right.
So the idea that he can strike up a friendship with dudes that, I mean, I don't know if they've seen his movies. Maybe they have, but you're right. I'd love to know. But how about this? So he gets the lifetime pass because he is buds with the band. And then apparently did not last long. He got the pass revoked, and he's on the Late Late Show with James Corden talking all about this.
I went to see the Rolling Stones in Argentina. We got these special laminates, all access, that were good for the rest of your life. That night at the concert, I'm kind of wandering around, and I ended up right at this place where I could look over and see Mick Jagger, and then all of a sudden he bolts during Jumping Jack Flash and comes running down, and it turns out where I was kind of part of the stage, and then someone came running over, "Get out of here, move, you're not supposed to be here." And then I get a call the next morning from Mick's security team, "Do you have that laminate?" "Yes, I still have it." "Okay, we're going to come over and pick it up."
But they revoked your whole pass?
The lifetime pass?
Yeah, the lifetime pass.
Whoa.
You only had it for one day.
For one show.
Oh, I feel like you should at least get a do-over.
Oh, they probably have zero tolerance. They're like, dude, what the hell? Why were you standing right there?
Yeah. Oh, man, dude.
Oh,
that's crazy.
Well, at least you got to enjoy it once, and it makes for a good story.
Yeah, sure does.
I feel like I would do something like that. Like,
unintentionally.
Green Day gives me, like, lifetime passes to shows, and then all of a sudden I do something and I mess it all up.
Yeah, I would hope for like a Pearl Jam lifetime pass.
Yeah.
And travel around, and then I'm the guy that gets caught stealing a tambourine.
I was going to say, you have a lifetime tambourine.
Or I'm like the guy, like I push the guy out of the way, and I'm the guy who hands Eddie the tambourine. I'm like, here you go, Eddie. High five.
I would love good seats, but I have been backstage to so many different things, mm-hmm. and it's not a fun time. A lot of times they're really like professional and they don't want you to mess things around. And you and I have been backstage where some of the people that we were with did not respect that, and then we ended up getting kicked out.
Oh, I remember one, I can't remember what band it was, but I remember their road crew looking on, effing radio guys. And yeah, I'm just like,
I know.
And I look at them, I'm like, dude, we don't want to be here just as much as you don't want us here, but our work wants us to do a stage announcement. So give us the freaking microphone. We'll get up there, we'll say our piece, and we'll get the hell out of your way. Like, we're only back here so we could do what we're asked to do, and then we're going to leave you guys alone. We don't think it's cool to be back here.
Yeah, it's
But if you're Owen Wilson,
yeah,
I bet like everyone's really excited to have Owen Wilson.
That's
backstage.
What I would think.
Like if I'm Owen Wilson, yeah, like if all of a sudden you're probably like, dude, that's Owen Wilson. Hey, come on, here's a guitar pick.
So he didn't shed light as to who he was friends with, but I don't think it was Mick.
Clearly not.
Yeah, because I think Keith. Probably Keith. Keith seems like he would be friends with everybody. It's funny, I'm watching that interview.
It was Charlie, and they're like, wow, man, Charlie passed away.
So now we're going to take the pass back because we don't really like this guy.
We never wanted him back here. Now look at him. He's crossing the line.
Dude, it's funny you brought up Charlie because if you go see the video, you can watch the James Corden interview. We have the video clip on the BJ and Migs page of KISW.com. I thought, at first, when I'm watching this video, I thought that there's Owen Wilson next to Charlie Watts.
I kind of thought the same thing.
And then I realized, wait, Charlie's passed away. And then it's like, oh, no, that's Jeff Goldblum.
It's Jeff Goldblum.
When did Jeff Goldblum turn into Charlie Watts? When did that happen?
With his hair, the way that he has his hair styled, it looked just like him. Like, it's super gray.
Yeah, they have a similar facial structure. I totally didn't recognize
that. They both have that kind of, like, that cool look to them. Like, their hair is, like, that artsy-fartsy kind of, like, part. And I mean that in a very endearing way, of course. Yeah, it's got the swoop.
And they're very uncomfortably close to each other. Like on a talk show, I feel like Jeff and Owen are too close. I thought Owen, because Owen was using his hands to tell the story, I thought he was going to knock Jeff's glasses off.
Owen looks like he's at a gentleman's club. He's sitting on his hands right now so that he doesn't touch.
His legs are open, too. That's not good, man.
That shows where our brains are. I was like, oh, he's at the principal's office. I'm in trouble.
At the gentleman's club. He's like, yo, if I sit on my hands can't go anywhere they're not supposed to go.
I can't get kicked out.
That's right. Sit on your hands, sir.
What a and I have to tell you, Jeff Goldblum's a trippy guy. Just to be on the same set or even in an interview with and next to that guy, because even he goes, really, man, wow, you lost the ticket, eh? I mean, just that way Jeff is.
He has that look to him. All right, so Danny's going with probably Green Day for a lifetime all access pass. Is that what we're thinking?
Oh yeah.
A Pearl Jam for me, I would imagine, like especially because that band always does different shows in every town that they go in, so that would be a lot of fun to travel.
That's funny you say that because most people would think like Offspring for me, but the Offspring they kind of do the same show every single time,
right?
Green Day mixed it up, that's why I'm going with Green Day.
That's why Pearl Jam and Gloria Sons would be another one too. Like I love the fact that they always change up their sets and so it makes every show a fun experience. All right, so Vicky, who are you going with? Lifetime backstage pass, don't F it up.
It's gonna be in this moment because they always put on a ridiculous show. Costume changes, like pyrotechnics, amazing dancers with masks, and all this craziness. It is phenomenal.
And honestly, I agree. They put on a great show. I wouldn't even abuse the lifetime pass to like hang out backstage. Mm-hmm. I would just be in the common area, like the general admission area where you like, you know, the pit, just to be able to like not have to deal with anything. I can just flash the pass and go wherever I want. But I wouldn't abuse the privilege.
Yeah, it depends on whether you're if you really are friends with somebody, that's different because they're happy to see you.
Yeah.
And you're smart enough to know that they actually are doing a job and you don't want to get in the way because you get it. You know, you go, hey, how good to see you, Jim. We'll talk to you later. You know, that kind of a thing. But yeah, I'm like you. I don't need to be backstage.
No. In fact, I prefer not to be. Like, yeah. So for you, BJ.
Does it have to be music? Because, I mean, here's the thing that they do
a lot. Well, I'd like to hear your answer. My first thought was, come on, man. Yes, of course it does. But what are you thinking?
All right, musically, I would love to be backstage. God, you know what, dude? The way you talk about the Gloria Sons, I think I would like to be backstage for those guys. I would have definitely said Avril Lavigne or my boys Collective Soul. Even though you guys hate them, I still love them.
I've had a couple fun experiences with the Gloria Sons backstage where a lot of tequila has been drunk and Brett the singer ends up with like Sharpie on his face. And like it's a very, very fun-loving group of guys.
But you know what? We're fortunate because when we do Pain in the Grass, we get to be backstage with so many different bands. And like last year, we were backstage with Thunder Pea. And I love those. Those guys are awesome. They were so fun. And so if it's an experience like that, that's the kind of experience I want. You don't always get that with some of the bands that you go, I can't wait to be backstage with the band, big band that we play. And you realize they just don't want you.
I remember with the Glorious Sons being in the back at the show box. And I was like a beaten dog. Like I went back there and I'm like, I just pushed up against a corner as humanly possible because I'm like, stay out of everybody's way. I don't want to get in trouble.
Yes.
And then I start talking. And I'm like, wait, you guys know I'm here? Like, you know what I mean? Like, you feel like you're in the way, but I was like, I was doing the stage announcement. But I was like, I just want to stay out of their way. But then they're so endearing and so conversational. I'm like, wait, you're not like all the other bands. Well, you're actually happy to see us.
It's funny you say that because, like, there's been times, I mean, I've been going to concerts since I was 12 years old. And sometimes, like, you see a band and you meet them and they're super cool back when they're, like, super small. And then you see them years later, and they're just like, you can tell they've gone past that, forgot who they were. They don't want anyone like going in certain places backstage. And it's like, what happened? Come on, guys. Like, remember where you came from.
The road, man. It hardened them, brah.
So,
someone said backstage for Metallica.
Ooh.
That's okay. Can't argue with that.
I would like that one if the band likes you. Like, I mean, obviously.
Yes.
Because they always jam before their shows. Like, they have an actual jam room. Like, they have a practice space in the facility, like in the venue. Like, they'll have drums, amps, and they just kind of like warm up that way.
Yeah.
And that'd be a blast to be able to just like sit back and just watch them get ready. And like,
haven't you been there not knowing if you were liked or not?
Oh, I was positive we weren't liked.
Yeah, that's the thing.
I was back there and we were, and James Hetfield, well, no, in all fairness, Lars was really cool. Kirk was beyond cool. Like, Kirk Hammett might be the nice. Robert Trujillo, also very nice. And I'm not saying this is a negative thing towards James Hetfield because he's one of my favorite rock stars and still like a bucket list to get like a picture with the guy and talk to him. But he was in the zone.
Yeah.
And he walked in and there were two people in that room that were not in Metallica. And he told us to leave. He's like, what are you guys doing here? Get out.
Yep, that's it.
And it wasn't like he was like being like, get the F out. He was like, what do you got? And he's like, you guys got to get out. It wasn't like, he was very abrupt about it. But like, yeah. I didn't leave thinking.
Very direct.
I didn't think he was a jerk. I was like, this is his world, and we're in it.
Still a horrible feeling knowing that you're in the wrong place.
I did press my ear up against the door and listen.
Oh, did you? Good for you.
I was so nervous I didn't open up that door. Like, what if James Hetfield opened up that door?
Oh, and there you are.
I've got my ear up against the door.
You're
that guy. Hi, James.
Did you have a glass like the old school TV shows?
If one was near me, I would have used it, DJ.
Oh, man, that's fantastic. How about you, Joey D's, if you can be backstage anywhere?
Oh, that'd be easy. I just pick Taylor Swift and rent out the pass.
And rent out the pass.
Oh, I get it. He's involved for the financial gain.
It's not a bad idea. It's just like the biggest thing that's ever been a thing.
But you'd lose that pass in one show.
Yeah, you would.
Yeah, maybe. But I'd get a lot of money for it.
See, up until you said rent out the pass, I'm like, damn it, that's a great answer. I get to be backstage and hang out with Taylor Swift.
Yeah.
In for that.
Well, you get to do it the first time, then you rent it out.
Now, see, what you do, Joe, is if you're able to score, like, a pass that includes a guest, that's how you get the ladies.
Oh, that's true, actually.
Oh, yeah, there's
no way. Want to come see Taylor Swift with me?
Yeah, if you walked around anywhere, everyone would be like, yes, I would,
I would do things to Joe for an opportunity.
I put so far out, it would be ridiculous, yeah.
Wow, that's not
so said, well, how was Stone Temple Pilots? They could not be nicer. They wanted to know how they were backstage.
Oh, yeah, dude, I mean.
It was almost like, it was
awesome.
It was overwhelmingly nice. Like it was very cool to see a band on that level. Like they've toured a lot, and they don't have to be nice. They couldn't be sweeter to everybody that they had a chance to talk to. Like, I saw them taking pictures with everybody, all the radio people, engaging in conversation, and of course, my experience was on another level because I got to play drums that day. But like, I watched how they were to everybody else, and it wasn't like they treated me any different because like, oh, he's playing drums, we should be nice to him.
Yeah, you know, and our business hasn't done itself any favors. And when I say our business, I'm going to talk about the talent end. Dude, I just watched a podcast recently with Tom Segura, the comic, and David Cross.
Okay.
And, oh, they ripped our business apart because of, you know the kind of people. We go to our conventions, and the kind of people that are just jackasses to everybody in any other industry when they're on the show or they're backstage.
Mm-hmm.
And it breaks your heart because, you know, it's just professional. If you're a professional, if you just hold yourself as a professional, everybody will like you in every other industry. They'll go, all right, this dude's a professional. But man, you know, the reason why we have to wonder when we go backstage anywhere is because they know we're in this business, and we end up taking a lot of arrows for what other people in our business have done.
There's a lot of dorks in our industry.
You're right.
Dorks, no dorks, but for different reasons. But
yeah,
like, there are some that just don't understand, like, hey, act like you've been here, or at least if you don't can't act that way, then don't be back there.
Yeah.
It's that simple.
And it sucks, man. This is a recent interview, and I love comedy, and, you know, and, oh, man, they just ripped our business apart, and I'm just like... You know, and again, like you said, it's because of the dorks, man. And it breaks my heart because I feel like you and I and everybody on this show, we do act like we've been there. We even act better than that. We go, thank you for letting us be here. Mm-hmm. And, you know, and just walking around here, and we hope we don't get in the way. We don't want to get in the way, and we'll even leave if you want us to.
We are the gold standard of radio talent.
Okay, finally.
It's about time that people recognize.
It's finally been said.
You know, we have to stop being humble about it.
Now, here's the deal. Okay, would like backstage passes to movie premieres.
Huh?
Oh, dude, whenever they have a movie or a TV show, sometimes they're doing it, they'll have a world premiere where they have a live audience in a theater.
Okay.
But only select people get to do that. Like, you're the first person to see whatever. And now TV shows are doing it.
Oh, I was like, why do you want to be in the backstage of a movie? You
can't and watch the people the are then. There. Like, the people are there.
Like, the actors, like a red carpet event almost?
I got to do that one time for Star Trek II that came out.
Okay.
And because Simon Pegg, even though you say he's not in front of our show, but I think he is. He's my buddy.
I mean, he just acts like he is.
But he let me come back there and host the whole thing. And, dude, it's such a great experience because here I am hanging with all of the luminaries of that movie that are going to be out. I also got to do it for Kevin Smith. And Kevin Smith is such a fantastic dude when you're on stage with him or when you're backstage. You know, I'd never met him personally, but we had him on the show.
Another guy like that. Exactly. Doug's always great. That's a good guy to bring up.
Love to be part of that every time because, man, it is such a fun thing because, I love movies, TV. I love that kind of stuff. I love comedy. So I would love to have a backstage pass to all of those kind of things.
Like that's how it was. Like that experience when I got to do with All Elite Wrestling, when I got to be one of the extras and actually have a match.
Yeah.
I would be okay with never having a match, but just touring with them and being in that back area because A, they treat everybody like gold, which I thought was really cool to see. Nobody was treated like make anyone feel that they were beneath them or whatever. Like, but really at the end of the day, the catering BJ is on another level. It was an experience of a lifetime. Like, and they change it every show because the Seattle catering was different than the Portland catering, and they got something for everyone. Desserts, BJ.
Oh, God,
you would gain a billion pounds, dude, in 1 month.
I don't want to hear about how great this is, dude. The
wrestling is like a funny, like almost like a joke on the wrestlers because some of these guys are just like they got muscles on top of muscles, and they have that because they're very good and disciplined with what they eat.
Yeah,
and then all you go back there and it's like a giant cheesecake.
Oh,
and you're like, what are you doing? I'd be so mad if I'm one of the wrestlers. Like, you, what are you, dude? This is a body business, brother, and you're making me have all these damn cheesecakes in front of me?
Isn't that like a thing with like competitive, like when you're muscly and you want to look veiny, you're supposed to consume sugar?
Is that true?
I watched like a bodybuilding documentary once. I don't know why. It was on. And it was
Nikki
about,
is the expert on everything that she's never done, but what she's watched.
It was about women doing it, and so they were consuming candy and soda right before so their veins would pop.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Oh. See, I only use Viagra for that.
Anyways.
I see some of the guys I know in the world of wrestling, they've been doing that. I don't know if this is a new thing, but they're putting hot sauce on their skin. It darkens the skin and it brings it brings out the veins. I don't understand.
I didn't know veins was a thing you wanted to see in people. I don't want to see that.
Yeah, it makes the whole like looking vascular. It's like
that's an intentional look
for a lot of bodybuilders. Absolutely,
I didn't realize that. I thought there was just like there was something wrong with them.
No, if you're showing a lot of veins, that means that you're like.
I don't like that.
You got muscles.
Okay.
Yeah, that's a big thing for a lot of guys and girls, obviously.
You know what? I guess,
you don't like people being veiny?
I don't like. No, I really don't.
See, I'm very vascular on my forehead.
You really are.
So many bodybuilders are jealous of this vein on my forehead.
Now I know why.
Yeah.
I can't. There's places I don't want to go now. With that conversation,
then don't go there.
I'm not going to. Okay. Instead, I'm going to tell you. Yesterday, Steve was wrong about this.
In Saved by the Bell, the main characters create a band called what?
The Killers.
No.
I don't know. Damn it. Oh, boy. I'm going to go with Gem and the Hologram.
No.
Sorry. Steve.
Pearl Jam.
No.
Wow. You're disappointed, Dan.
I said in Danny, but he didn't even know it.
He didn't know it either. He knew the song they sang and thought that was the name of the band.
Yeah.
There is somebody on Saved by the Bell named Zach, right?
Yeah,
Zach
Morris.
Okay. I don't watch the show. I never watched the show.
Come on, BJ.
It's after my time, jerks. Yeah.
So, you know, there's a guy named Jerry on the show Seinfeld.
That was during my time, Steve.
It's just like you need to know these things.
You know, there's a guy named Batman in Batman.
Yeah.
Okay. What's his name?
Bat.
His name is Bat.
Got one guess on what his last name is.
You know what? I feel like I have been roped into another conversation with morons. I'm getting out of this.
We are the gold standard of radio professionals. What are you talking about?
Not about that, yeah. Somebody tell Tom Segura and David Cross, come to see us, buddy. We're the gold standard. All right, Zach Attack, by the way, was the answer. You wanna beat Steve? You got it. 206-803-ROCK. We're playing Beat Migs at 847 on The Rock.
Today's podcast was brought to you by Travis Gagne, bankruptcy attorney. Here's another question from a listener. How long is a bankruptcy going to affect my credit rating?
Of course, most of the time, by the time we're talking about filing a bankruptcy, the credit has already taken a huge hit. Chapter 7 is going to affect it more negatively than Chapter 13. Chapter 7 stays on your credit report for 10 years from the time you file. It usually takes 7 or 8 years for your credit scores to get back into the normal range in a Chapter 7 case. However, your credit will start to recover even in Chapter 7 after about a year. You'll be able to get credit again right away, usually before your case is even over. Chapter 13 stays on your credit report for 7 years and usually takes about 3 to 3.5 years for your credit to get back in the normal range. So Chapter 13 will mean your credit gets better much more rapidly.
Thanks, Travis. If you have more questions about bankruptcy, you can reach out to Travis anytime at ChooseTheRightChapter.com. That's ChooseTheRightChapter.com. Thanks for listening.
T-Mobile's network can help keep you connected to all your favorite podcasts when you're out and about. Whether you're an early bird looking to dive into a daily news podcast or a night owl who wants to catch up on the latest reality TV drama, T-Mobile will keep you connected on their strong and reliable network. T-Mobile covers more highway miles with 5G than anyone. So if you need great coverage, especially when you're on the go, check out T-Mobile. Find out more at T-Mobile.com/CY. That's SEEWHY.
High schoolers are busy, but no one's too busy to help fight blood cancer. The Leukemia and Lymphoma Society is looking for our next Student Visionaries of the Year. With a little initiative, chosen students can change the lives of real patients and help be a part of the last generation to see blood cancer. Learn more about our program and how to nominate a young visionary in your community at lls.org/student-visionaries. That's lls.org/student-visionaries.
If you need rehab after surgery, help at home, or if you need a place to enjoy the best years of your life after 60, Carriage is here for you. Carriage is a family-owned healthcare and senior living company that puts people first. Let us provide you with short-term, post-acute rehabilitation at one of our skilled nursing facilities in Bellevue and Renton. Expert in-home care and support to clients throughout Washington. Or enjoy a vibrant retirement in elegant, amenity-rich surroundings in Washington and California. Learn more at Carriage.com.
Southern Company is making energy smart and sustainable for their 9 million customers across the country. From modernizing infrastructure to achieving their interim carbon reduction goal 10 years early, Southern Company is committed to building a clean, resilient energy future. Learn more at southerncompany.com/future. Southern Company, building the future of energy.
Have you been in an accident that wasn't your fault? Feeling overwhelmed and unsure what to do next? Look no further. The personal injury attorneys at Phillips Law Firm are here to help. Phillips Law Firm understands that accidents can turn your life upside down. That's why they're dedicated to fighting for the compensation you deserve and to making the process as stress-free as possible. Don't wait any longer. Call now, 1-800-JUSTICE, or visit justiceforyou.com.
Let's face it. Sometimes multitasking can be overwhelming, like when your favorite podcast is playing and the person next to you is talking and your car fan is blasting, all while you're trying to find the perfect parking spot. But then again, sometimes multitasking is easy, like quoting with Progressive Insurance. They do the hard work of comparing rates so you can find a great rate that works for you, even if it's not with them. Give their nifty comparison tool a try, and you might just find getting the rate and coverage you deserve is easy. All you need to do is visit Progressive's website to get a quote with all the coverages you want, like comprehensive and collision coverage or personal injury protection. Then you'll see Progressive's direct rate, and their tool will provide options from other companies all lined up and ready to compare. So it's simple to choose the rate and coverage you like. Press play on comparing auto rates. Quote at Progressive.com to join the over 29 million drivers who trust Progressive. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Comparison rates not available in all states or situations. Prices vary based on how you buy.
Hey, this is BJ. Thanks for listening to our show's podcast. If you're a fan of all things geeky, you should check out my other podcast, BJ Shea's Geek Nation. We have new episodes every day, and you can check it out at bjgeeknation.com.
Your home is going into foreclosure, and you feel like a financial wreck. You don't know where to turn for accurate information. I'm bankruptcy attorney Travis Gagne. Let's talk about some legal options. If we work quickly, we can propose a plan to save your home, modify the loan, or in many cases, even eliminate your second mortgage. The consultation is free. I've helped hundreds of people just like you make informed decisions about whether to save their home or exit it on a reasonable, organized timeline. The chapter you choose sets the tone for the next chapter of your life. Please contact me today at ChooseTheRightChapter.com. That's ChooseTheRightChapter.com.
99.9 KISW, the Rock of Seattle. A week from tomorrow, next Friday, it's Seattle Rock Day, baby. It's back.
Getting fired up to have a great day of listening to some of our favorite Northwest bands and also helping raise money for a great cause. So hopefully people go to our website and donate money, and there's going to be an auction as well, all for Smash.
Yeah, and Smash is Seattle musicians' access to sustainable health care. It's a simple thing. Musicians do not work for big companies, therefore they don't have benefits. They got to get it all on their own. And I think we all know benefits are expensive if you got to do it all by yourself. But Smash gives them access to medical, dental, mental health services at a very low cost and sometimes even for free. And that's where your donations come in handy. And why not give back to people that just make your life better with all the great music they do? Also Palace Law, thank you, because they help us every year with bringing Seattle Rock Day to you. And Steve, this year, not only Seattle Rock Day, but Seattle Rock Night.
That's right. We're going to be enjoying some great music over at Madame Lou's in Belltown, which is like right by, it's underneath the Crocodile Cafe, and all the information is at KSW.com. The New Originals are a band that features myself, Thrill, Ryan Castle, a bunch of our friends like Glenn Cannon and Kyle Court and Joey. We're all going to be out there rocking out and playing some of your favorite Seattle songs, as well as Wyatt Only in the Wreckage, Glenn Cannon and The Damage Done, and a few other surprises as well, including one of the surprises with the New Originals. It's going to be really, really cool. I'm excited to get behind
the
kid and play with this individual.
Oh.
It's going to be awesome.
Oh.
Yeah.
All right. You want all the info about Seattle Rock Day and Seattle Rock Night at Madame Lou's? You go to KISW.com.
Let's play Migs. It's time to play the game.
Don't.
So everybody scream his name. Be Migs. Don't be a loser.
I thought we were professionals. Gold standard. Migs.
Tin standard.
Well, happy Friday, Junior, everybody.
Yeah, here we are.
Feels like we're kind of going into another multiverse. Like, what's going on?
Not at all, man. It's opening day, baby.
Well, that's what I mean. All the sports. Can you believe how many years ago were we wanting hockey? Now we're having so many sports, we can't decide what we're going to.
Yeah. Look, I love hockey and everything, but today's baseball's day. I know that the Kraken are playing tonight. I know that you guys are going to the fancy suite.
Oh, dude, don't get me wrong. I'm still very hyped up and fired up for it. I chose on the day of Kraken or Mariners. I'm wearing a Seattle Mariners shirt.
Yeah, what?
That's why you got to get your sock game. Then you can do both.
I'm not going to get my sock game. I do have a Kraken hat, so I am also showing some love for the Kraken.
Or when you get your jersey, your City Select, then you just wear your Kraken shirt under like I did today.
Yeah,
I'm just wearing
a
Mariners one.
Yeah, so you can make it happen, but you know what? It's a great day for Seattle sports. I'm fired up to see the Kraken, but I'm also fired up to see the Mariners start their season.
Woo, you can always be like me and go to a thrift store and buy an old lady vest with the Mariners on one side and Snoopy playing baseball on the other side.
I found this DIY vest that's hysterical.
$2.99 at a thrift store. It is phenomenal.
I wouldn't pay more than $1.99 for it.
I mean, only because it's got little gems that make it sparkle.
Okay, fine.
Yes, that is why I paid extra dollars.
It does look like grandma should be wearing that, and you'd love her for doing it.
Obviously, someone went to the fabric store and got a Mariners fabric and made a vest out of it.
Yeah. It was so ridiculous. Part of me is like, I'm going to be very disappointed if I don't buy this. I'm going to be thinking about it all day, so I ended up buying it.
And you'll never be able to find it again.
No, and I didn't want to make it.
It is so grandma.
I'll have to take a picture of it and show it to you guys. But until then, we do have a game to get to. We have Travis from Texas. Travis, are you there?
Go Mariners, go Kraken.
Hell yeah! That's what's up, Travis.
All right, Steve, get out of here. For those playing at home, Travis has 60 seconds to answer 10 questions. You can pass all you want, but you do only get 3 guesses per question. Are you ready?
Yeah.
In The Walking Dead, what was the nickname given to Negan's baseball bat?
Pass.
In what decade did the Barbie doll make her first appearance on the market?
30s, 40s, 50s.
50s, yes. Beginning with the letter J, what is the real first name of actor Jason Momoa?
John.
No.
Jacob.
No.
Jingleheimer.
No. Saul Hudson is better known as what musician?
Paul McCartney.
No.
Pat.
Which president's mother was a wrestler in her day?
Clinton.
Nope.
Bush.
No.
Reagan.
No. A gambling token shares its name with what food item?
A what?
A gambling token shares its name with what food item?
Pass.
What form of candy is mentioned in the chorus of Candy Shop?
Pass.
What is the name of Han Solo's ship in Star Wars?
Millennium Falcon.
Yes, that is too correct.
Oh, he dropped a deuce. That's nice. Oh, Travis calling all the way from Texas, listening on the Odyssey app.
I'd like to blame the distance.
Yeah. Yeah, well, the phone connection wasn't that great either.
Yeah.
We're having our phone. I might have to burn our phone system to the ground.
That's called arson, and I don't think a show that has the gold standard of radio should be doing something like that.
All right, well, you know, I'm going to have to find then someone who's the gold standard of arson.
Okay.
That way we're back up to your level of, you know, quality.
Fair.
Are you ready, Steve?
Oh, yeah!
In The Walking Dead, what was the nickname given to Negan's baseball bat?
Lucille.
Yes.
Nice.
In what decade did the Barbie make her first appearance on the market?
40s.
No.
30s.
No.
50s.
Yes.
Yes.
Beginning with the letter J, what is the real first name of actor Jason Momoa?
Jarvicious.
No.
John.
No.
Jason?
No. Saul Hudson is better known as what musician?
Slash.
Yes. Which president's mother was a wrestler in her day?
Which president's mother? Abraham Lincoln.
Yes. A gambling token shares its name with what food item?
Gambling token to pony.
No.
Ante.
No.
Dollar.
No. What form of candy is mentioned in the chorus of Candy Shop?
Candy Shop. I'm going to have a Reese's Peanut Butter Cup.
No.
I don't know. I'm going to go Skittles.
No.
M&M's.
No. What is the name of Han Solo's ship in Star Wars?
The Millennium Falcon.
Correct. What toothy name did Hagrid's huge pet dog have in the Harry Potter novels?
Snarl.
No.
Good old Snarl.
No.
Gummer.
No. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Correct. That is a win. 5-2.
Oh, yes. Sorry, Travis. But you knew, and your phone is horrible, so. Yeah, that's what happens when you go, you move to Texas, you get horrible phones.
Good day, Sam.
Yes. Yeah. Not everything's big there.
No, it's not. Big problems.
Yeah, look at this.
Does anybody know what Jason Momoa's real first name is?
All right, you know, this is why I hate this question, because you only get two guesses. Because you have to say Jason. Mm-hmm. So you really only get two guesses. And it would...
Well,
you do, because it's a trick question. It could be a trick question.
But that's up to you to do it, though.
Yeah, you don't have to.
Well, I would say you really have to, because won't you be pissed if it's Jason and you don't guess Jason? If you don't know, you got to. That's what I'm saying. So I would say Jeremy or Jerome.
Nope.
See, that's why I hate this question.
Jeffrey.
No. Hey, Joey.
Joey.
What do you think it is?
Is it Joe? It's Joseph?
Joseph.
Yeah. Wow, I would not have thought that.
Sorry, Joe. He was about to say it.
Oh, sorry, Joe.
Yep. A gambling token that shares its name with what food item?
A gambling token?
A chip.
Oh, my God. That is a good question.
The easiest question ever.
Yeah.
And Danny looked really fired up to even say that.
I did.
Yeah.
Because the guy was like, chip.
I want to be mad at Vicky, but that was a very proper question.
Sometimes the easiest answer is the hardest one to say.
Sure. And I thought wording this next question would make it obvious, I guess, in my head that it wasn't supposed to be like a brand name candy, but like what kind of candy is mentioned in the course of Candy Shop.
I've totally thought it was a brand name candy.
Lollipop. Yeah. I would have said what type. No, you're right.
You didn't. Yeah.
I tried.
Well. Yeah, you know,
you tried. I failed.
Euphemistically, I knew he wasn't talking about that. That's why I wasn't even thinking of that.
What are you talking about? Of course he was. And
of course, who doesn't love lollipops?
Cardi B's talking about a cat that got sprayed with a hose.
Cats do not like
being wet.
Totally, I've just totally forgot lollipop because I know what he's talking about.
Yes. And when they say "Come on, ride the train," great song.
Choo choo.
It's about actually getting on the light rail.
Of course,
right.
Yeah.
And what toothy name did Hagrid's huge pet dog have in the Harry Potter novels?
I love Toothy. That was a good clue.
It was.
Danger.
Fang.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
Denture.
Dancer. Oh, that's a dancer.
No, yeah. Denture.
I gotcha.
Dentine.
Yeah. Yeah. Sensodyne.
Root canal.
Right. That's it. Come here, root canal.
I like it.
All right, it is time for Listeners on the Loose. That means it's your time. Yeah, your time to shine. No one listens to you? We will. 206-803-ROCK. That's the number to call. That's also the number to text. We got your calls. We got your texts at 917 on The Rock.
BJ and Migs, mornings on The Rock, 99.9 KISW.
99.9 KISW, The Rock of Seattle. It's Listeners on the Loose, where you pick the topic, you guide the show. 206-803-ROCK. That's the number to call. That is the number to text. 206-803-ROCK. When you get through, do what Steve wants you to do.
And that's to show some energy and bring it. Otherwise, we're going to have to gong you. And then say goodbye.
Goodbye, old friend.
Call us, text us, 206-803-ROCK.
Someone said, Migs, you want to feel old? It was 20 years ago today that WrestleMania 19 happened here at what was then called T-Mobile Stadium, T-Mobile Stadium here in Seattle.
Wow.
20 years ago, WrestleMania 19, BJ.
Wow. Where was what was that? T-Mobile Stadium. What was
not
that?
T-Mobile Stadium. It's Safeco Field. Sorry.
Safeco Field.
I got my damn sponsors. It was Safeco Field at the time.
I'm sorry.
I was trying to correct myself, but I still gave it the current name and added a weird ending
to
it.
Good job. You did a great job.
Yeah, gold standard.
How many years ago?
20 years ago today.
God.
It was 2003, and it was a great WrestleMania.
Man, you feel old because, when you take a look at T-Mobile Park, I think it's getting closer to being older than the Kingdome ever was.
Yeah, and it still looks great.
It's insane.
Uh-huh.
It's insane to think that people are complaining like, oh, my God, I can't believe it.
But it's like the Jennifer Lopez of baseball stadiums.
Yeah, you're right.
Yeah, it just ages really well.
It is. T-Mobile Park is still, I think, granted, I haven't been to all the ballparks, but I've been to a lot of them, and it is an elite, elite ballpark.
It is crazy because also someone brought up, and that meant also that Limp Bizkit played at WrestleMania 19. There was a video that's showing up 20 years ago. Limp Bizkit, they performed at WrestleMania to let bring the Undertaker out. And I remember getting to interview Fred Durst at Safeco Field, like before the show even started. Look back on that. Nice. I wish I had some kind of film crew to be able to document those moments because it's like your memory only remembers so much. And all I remember from that interview was that Fred was in a weird state of mind. He was super nice. He was always nice when I got to interview him. Like one of the more easy guys to talk to, which is funny because everyone thought he was kind of a douche. I never had a bad experience with the guy. Nice. Every interview. But he was in a weird, he started opening up about his feelings about Britney Spears.
Oh wow.
Because it was around that time where they were allegedly hanging out, and he was getting kind of emotional about it.
Wow.
And I'm just I'm 20 years old, and 20-something years old, and I'm just I have no advice for you, man. I can't even get laid if I tried. You're Fred Durst. I was man, sorry to hear that. I had nothing.
See, that's the kind of interview I would love.
Well, yeah.
Man, here's this guy crying before I even get there.
Well, dude, now I'd have a lot easier time talking to him about that, but I'm I have no life experience, and I'm just dude, I love Nookie. That's a cool song.
Don't you know she's the love of my life, man?
But I remember it was so surreal. He was so cool, but you could tell he was dealing with something in his head at that moment that was not, he was not in a good mind.
Oh, damn, dude.
Also, BJ, T-Mobile has been around for 24 years. The Kingdome was only around for 22.
So that's how crazy. About T-Mobile Park is older than the Kingdome? Because the Kingdome was a pile. I mean, by the time it got to year, 20? It was a pile.
Yeah.
And it's amazing how new that T-Mobile still looks. It's just, and it's older. It's just nuts.
Yeah, it's crazy. And the thing about that WrestleMania is historic. I mean, that was technically Steve Austin's last match ever.
Oh,
and he didn't make an announcement of that. He just after the match was over, he's I'm done because of his neck and all of his body. He eventually came back last year and did something, but that was his last time really in the ring, and it was against The Rock.
Oh, wow, that's a long time ago, because who was The Rock back then? Had he done The Mummy or anything by then?
No, I think he was just a superstar wrestler.
Yeah.
He was just a huge star in the world of wrestling.
Yeah, man. And
that was great. Hulk Hogan wrestled Vince McMahon. Brock Lesnar nearly died. He did this giant shooting star press thing. The last time he ever did it. He on the top of Brock Lesnar, big guy, does his backflip, lands on his head.
Oh, damn, dude.
And still had it, and still finishes the match.
Oh.
And then made it very clear. He's I'm never doing that move again.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, he could have died right there, man.
Oh, yeah, he could have.
In front of a bunch of people.
Dude, that's gnarly.
Oh, so crazy.
Speaking of WrestleMania, it's this weekend. People are asking if I'm going. I'm like, nope, staying home. I'm going to be watching it at home. But if you want a fun preview of WrestleMania, this week on the Megacast, I got to chat with Odyssey, our company, now has a wrestling podcast.
What?
And it's called Kick Rocks. And it's hosted by Evan T-Mac. He's an awesome dude. He used to work with the WWE on the show called The Bump and did other stuff as well. And now has a podcast called Kick Rocks with his wife, which I think is brilliant. He gets to watch wrestling, and it's part of his job.
Look at this.
His wife has to watch it with him.
Nice.
But he's an awesome dude, and we preview WrestleMania. It's on this. It's one of the episodes this week on the Megacast.
Oh, very cool.
And then you can also listen to his podcast, Kick Rocks. It's an Odyssey exclusive.
Odyssey. A-U-D-A-C-Y. Get it where you get your apps at the App Store. And you can listen to us. You can listen to so much on the Odyssey app.
Yeah, someone said that. Brock Lesnar nearly broke his neck when he did that.
But he didn't break
his neck, which is crazy to think.
Well, if had that not been a wrestling ring where it has give, you know, like it does?
Not a lot of give, BJ.
Not a lot of give enough that you still could break your neck?
Oh, people have broken their necks.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Oh,
I thought there was a little give, and that's why.
It has a little give, absolutely.
Oh.
But not enough give. Like, people have broken their necks in the ring.
That's not good, then.
Yeah.
You shouldn't do that.
And from that height. It just shows us, I mean, that guy, he's got muscles all around.
He's got a thick neck.
Yeah, he does.
I'll give him that, but boy, that's a scary move.
So I remember my parents surprised my sister and I with tickets to go to WrestleMania. I remember seeing Limp Bizkit perform that song, haha. He had it in Rollin'.
Oh, yeah. Where is WrestleMania this year?
It's in California. It's in Los Angeles.
Oh,
SoFi Stadium. It's kind of like I'm having a little bit of a FOMO thing because, like, I went last year and I got to wrestle at one independent show and didn't get booked anywhere else. This year, it's like, a bunch of my friends are putting on shows, and I feel like if I picked the wrong year, I picked the wrong year to go and the wrong year not to go.
Though I will say the weather's been a beating.
Yeah,
you know, my wife just told me she was inside all day yesterday because of the rains.
Fortunately, all the wrestling things I was going to do are inside.
Okay, good enough.
Yeah. I mean, granted, the big thing WrestleMania is going to be outside at the Rams Stadium.
Yeah, so hopefully it's okay for that because I mean it's unprecedented the kind of rain they're getting.
That's crazy.
Yeah, so I mean I don't know what the forecast looks like, but I don't know, man. You know, because you feel like you can walk around town and have a great time, but it's like no, you can't.
Oh, man. All I've been seeing on people's social media pages, though, I think not a lot of people realize just how miserable traffic is in California.
Yeah.
They're like, I had to go, my hotel was 9 minutes from the airport. It took me 45 minutes.
I remember when we took Sarah to college, and it was literally a mile away to go to the Target store from where we were in downtown L.A. Yeah, it took a half hour.
Wow.
To go a mile.
That's insane.
Yeah, it's
almost like you just want to open up the door and just walk.
Yeah, at that point you go, yeah, this is really dumb.
It's
really, really dumb. And I'm so happy that we go to Orange County, nowhere near that kind of BS.
Yeah.
Yeah, because it's not good. Not good. It's Listeners on the Loose. You pick the topic. You guide the show. 206-803-ROCK. That's the number to call. That is the number to text. We got more of your calls, more of your texts. We'll take those at 9:33 on The Rock.
BJ and Migs, mornings on The Rock, 99.9 KISW.
You diet, you work out, and still there's that one stubborn spot. Hey, it's Jason. I just went after my stubborn fat by doing Cool Sculpting at Terreen Dermatology, Minnesota's top Cool Sculpting provider. Dr. Terreen is my dermatologist. We froze my fat, and those fat cells are gone for good. FDA approved. No pain, no downtime. Ranked top doctor 8 years in a row. Trust the experts at Terreen Dermatology. Call today, 651-633-6883, and say goodbye to stubborn fat.
Give dads and grads the gift of relaxation with Hand and Stone Massage and Facial Spa. Dads and Grads Season Ticket to Relax offers $30 off a massage or facial gift card or $70 off a massage and facial gift package. With 8 Seattle area locations, it's easy to find the one nearest you or explore exclusive online gift card sales. Let Hand and Stone help dads and grads restore, relax, and reset. Restrictions apply. See spa for more details.
What you watch depends on what kind of mood you're in. Sometimes you're craving comedies like Friends or South Park, and sometimes you're more into dramas like HBO's Succession and House of the Dragon. There's also cooking shows like Chopped and Beat Bobby Flay, and even movies like The Lord of the Rings and Shazam! Fury of the Gods. Well, Max is the streaming destination that has the best of entertainment for whatever mood you're in, anytime. And plans start at as little as $9.99 a month. Max, the one to watch. Subscription required. Visit max.com.
I was scared the night you overdosed, but I was prepared. I brought naloxone with me, and I knew how to use it. I held your hand tight when you woke up because I wanted you to feel safe. Your life is worth saving, friend, and I would save it again if I had to.
Naloxone can reverse an opioid or fentanyl overdose. Carry it with you. For more info, go to preventoverdosewa.org. A message from the Washington State Department of Health.
99.9 KISW, the Rock of Seattle. It's listeners on the loose. 206-803-ROCK. That's the number to call. That's the number to text.
Somebody wanted to know if any of us... there he is. Okay. They want to know what age was the best year of your life.
Oh, wow.
Deep questions on the Rock.
Wow. What age was the best year of my life?
Yes.
Oh, man.
I'd say my second year.
Oh, yeah, you were really amazing at two.
It was awesome. I could still pee and poop in my pants.
Yeah.
Nobody frowned upon it.
Oh, man.
Figured out how to walk.
Wow. Man. Boy,
wow, that's so fun. It's a no-brainer for me.
Does somebody actually have... My brain has a hard time figuring that out.
And as dorky as it's going to sound, it's this year.
Yeah.
Okay, tell me why.
Because I'm going to do everything I want to do in life. Like, I stopped caring about what other people think, and I'm just... I love doing this, obviously, for work. So that's
okay. You shouldn't
do
this because of what other people think.
Okay.
Yeah, because you don't.
I've got a kid that now likes me and wants to hang out with dad.
Yeah,
so
three. I told you to wait till three.
Yeah.
I said three is when you're going to dig a kid because they'll dig you back.
But even like one and two, which were very difficult. I don't really go too deep into that. But like it was hard because like she has no empathy and really just wants to be around mom and doesn't give an F about dad. Yeah. But every once in a while, we'd have moments. And that made it worth it. You know, and obviously, I'm looking at this adorable creature that wants nothing to do with me, but it's still adorable.
You're a nicer man than me. My kids were horrible at one and two.
They both were.
Oh, there were times where, man, yeah. I'm just like, God, this kid just hates me. Like, on the hierarchy of what she loves, it's mom, our dog, grandma, probably great grandma, maybe dad.
Maybe.
You know,
maybe.
Depending on the day, but probably one of her stuffed animals.
By the way, that's the same hierarchy we have here. We do love your dog, your grandma, the other grandma, much better than you. Everybody here's like that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I get to live out a dream that I never thought I'd get to do with wrestling, and that's an incredible ride that has just been very fulfilling, but also awkward because there's some people in my life, family, and that don't agree with it, and it's weird when you live something that you're doing something that you love to do, and people that you love don't really respect that. That's kind of annoying, but
yeah,
you know, you got to put your best foot forward, and that's okay. But yeah, I'd say all in all, like I obviously great wife, great kid. It's been a good year.
All right.
I'm just waiting for it all to come crashing down, but until it does, I'm going to enjoy it.
Well, this is, 2023, you're almost halfway through.
Yeah, let's go.
I mean, really.
Not really.
No, we're a quarter of a way. Yeah.
Quarter. Okay.
Yeah, quarter of a way through.
Math.
Yeah.
But I'm going to go with this year.
So your first quarter's been great. First quarter's been good for you.
But that's always been my goal, is that, like, especially once I got into my 40s, like, it was like almost like a light bulb. Like, why not? Instead of being like how, like, people in my life and my family and friends, like people would hit 40, they almost, like, stop living. You know what I mean? They just don't do anything.
Yeah.
This thing just kind of turned in my head. I was like, okay, no, like, live your best life. You only get one of them, and you're still young enough to be able to do things. Like, just do things to the best of your ability.
You're not talking to yourself there, are you? Because you're done. You're not young enough.
It's all downhill.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. But other people who are young enough should
I'm do. Younger than a 50-year-old.
That's very true.
And that's all I got to say. And then when I hit 50, I'm younger than a 55-year-old.
Yeah, well, you're always going to be younger than me.
I'm going to keep moving the goalpost, BJ.
Keep me around, and you'll always
you
be younger
die.
Than somebody.
Yeah.
That's my reason for living. There wasn't any other reason for me for living. All right, Vicky, how about you? Your best year?
That's kind of hard in the sense of, like, I can't figure it out because I loved my 20s. I loved when I did go out and everything. But I'm also loving, like, the last couple years, last year, I guess, being able to just dive into what I actually love doing, which is learning and trying new things. And if I want to do it, I'll do it. Like, if I want to start painting something, I'm going to start painting something. If I want to build something, I'm going to build it. Like, there's nothing really preventing
me from doing it. So last year's your best year?
This past year. Yeah, like,
okay.
Within this last
2022?
2022 and a little bit of the 2023 this past.
Okay, well.
You have
to pick a year. You didn't even do
it. I'll say 2022.
There we go.
What's wrong with 2023?
Yeah,
I didn't want to steal your thunder, Steve.
Yeah. I'm kidding.
All right, Danny, you know what? We'll get Sarah in here because I know what year it better be.
Oh, I know what year it's going to be.
Yeah, it better be. I mean, but we'll see. We could be wrong.
All right,
Danny V, do you have a year that you love?
Oh, see, I am stealing Steve's thunder. It is 2023. Let's go.
Really?
Not stealing crap. I want everyone to have that mentality.
No, it really
live
is
your best life.
Yeah, it's
Jesus.
Just do it.
I feel like I'm in an infomercial.
Yes, I've got something to sell at the end of this. Three easy installments.
Okay, fair enough.
There's nothing better than right now. Plus, you know, Lily's awesome. She's coming out here twice this year, which in the past she's only been out here
for the summer. She's already been out for spring break. Plus, I'm doing all the stuff with Emo Night. I get to hang out with you guys every day.
Yeah, that's not
my get to eat Cheetos. It's fantastic.
Get to go to Cracking Games.
Cracking Games.
We're sweet tonight.
We're BFFs with Bowie. Okay. Like, it's... Yeah.
Can we split into my DMs?
Yeah.
I mean, who else could say that?
Got to go to Vegas with Joe this year, which that we've been planning for years and finally made it happen, thanks to Sarah.
Yeah. All right, speaking of Joey D's, all right, Joey D's, how about you?
It better be this year. He discovered magic.
That's true.
Great Joe Genie.
Was that this year or last year, though?
Yeah.
Because I was going to say Christmas. Last year was one of the best years, but that's only because 2023 is not complete yet. You know, I can't judge it.
Got to be one of those guys.
Well, you got to
be. Not wrong about that yet. Like Steve is saying it's the best year ever when, you know what, tomorrow they could take it all away from him and he can be canceled by wrestling, canceled by radio.
Then you ask me the question tomorrow and I'll give you a different answer.
That's why
answer.
I think 2023 is the wrong year to say. Because you just say it isn't over yet. It's hard to say.
Okay, fine.
I mean, how can you say it's the best year ever when you haven't completed the year? This is the rule. That's why I can't be in these games. The rules lawyer in me goes, I've already failed.
Yeah.
All right. So, Joey, if it's not this year, then?
Yeah, I think it's last year. Last year was awesome.
Nice.
All right. 2022, that's not bad.
You're a magician.
Yeah.
I did everything last year. Yep. Hiking, magician, gambling, sports betting.
He's like
$5,000.
Uncle of the Year with Lily, too.
Out,
oh,
yeah.
This year he didn't do well. He's always done well gambling.
Oh, okay.
He really does. He pays for every one of his trips to Vegas because he's so good at the poker table. Now, that's the poker table. When he tries to play the chance games, yeah, I don't know about that.
We also got to return to boot camp last year, which was awesome.
Oh, the radio convention.
So much fun.
That was fun. All right, Sarah, so... Even though 2023 isn't complete, can you imagine any better year in the recent history?
I hate to be one of those people that is so like, my wedding was the most amazing day, but
you're fresh off of it.
I really am. So 2023, hands down, best year. It's not over and hopefully it doesn't become the worst year, but...
And you had some trials and tribulations earlier in this year, so that's still saying a lot.
Oh, yeah, and last year was horrible.
Yeah, last year sucked.
Everyone was like, oh, you're planning your wedding. Are you so excited? I'm like, no, I'm very stressed, actually. Yeah. So, no, this is not a great time right now.
Yeah, last year sucked.
But the actual day, perfect. So I'm going with 2023.
Nice.
If not, then I would probably choose, like, early 20s, you know? Right, 21, 22, when I was hot. I had the excuse to party, like, wild, my early 20s. Now I don't have that excuse.
But you still party like wild.
Yeah, but now people are like, you're in your early 30s. And now they're going to be like,
when are you going to grow up?
And you're married now. You're a wife. Yeah. You should be at home, you know.
That's when you go, bitch, don't kill my vibe.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. Yeah,
that's what I said to my mom and dad when they give me a hard time. I'm like, bitch, don't kill me.
Yeah. Don't kill my vibe.
They're like, you said what? I'm like, oh, I don't know. Weird kind of something. My phone got weird.
I would never say bitch to your parents. Sorry. No, never.
Yeah, you know what? I'm going to go selfish.
Well, that's the question. Of course you should go selfish.
Yeah, here's the thing, though. The selfish nature of it is it's all about me. You actually made it about other people in your life. I'm going to make it all about me.
Well, also, I mean, the wrestling thing is a very selfish thing.
Yeah, but you also, see, I'm going to go to a time where I'm not going to mention my kids. I'm not going to mention my wife.
Old were you in 1991 when I was born and brought into your life? Because that should be the answer, Father.
That was, if they asked me the worst year of my life, 1991 is definitely, it's up there, baby. I'm going to go, you know, Seattle, my radio career was okay. The best part of my career was working in Rochester, but with a guy who was really amazing. And I just was, I was on the show, but it wasn't my show. Coming here when the midday show on The Buzz was blowing up and we were doing live appearances and filling up places because the three of us idiots just found magic within a show that nobody knew and nobody paid attention. The company didn't even know what the hell we were doing, but we knew stuff was happening. And for my radio career, it was, I mean, everything that I have, I would say, was because of the moments where we became one of the biggest shows. And we weren't even a morning show. We were the stupid midday show, but we had so much buzz and we were on The Buzz.
Pun.
Even the rate, like we would go to conventions and we weren't even a morning show, but we were treated like a morning show when we would go to some of these conventions that we go to. And a lot of the consultants and a lot of the big wigs would say, if you want to be great, this is the show you want to be. So that was a great year. And that was somewhere, I don't know, in the 2000s.
I love that your favorite year of your life is a year you don't specifically remember.
Yeah, how old were you? No, you don't know that?
I was probably between 39 and 43.
Okay.
Yeah, it was before, you know. And, I mean, that was...
I love the guy who says, I'm the rules lawyer of questions, but I'm giving the most vague year.
You could literally make one up. 42. That was the best year of your life.
Yeah, well, I'm just, you know, it's easy for you clowns to go last year, but
well,
I
know it was 50 years ago that you were 42. But
I'm trying not to make this boring. I don't know exactly the year, but it was at that time when we... And the people listening who listen remember those days. It was somewhere, you know, between 1999 and 2005. I don't know when. All right, 2002. Let's say
it's
that.
Just funny because you gave us a hard time about
because
not having an exact year.
Because I don't want to bore everybody. I don't.
But you bored everybody by bitching about us picking a certain year.
Yeah, I did.
And that was a problem. And then all of a sudden you come back with, I don't know what year it was, but I don't want to bore anybody by giving you the year.
2002. How's that?
It's too late.
Yeah. Oh, now it's too late.
You already bored us.
Yeah, all right. Very good. Fair enough. And that has everything to do with me. And I will not mention anybody in my family. They were around, I'm sure.
Yeah, we were. Well, we were amazing. Thank you.
That's what we'd expect.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, I will tell you, because that's the thing to do nowadays, not knocking you guys, because I know you genuinely feel the way you feel. But that's the thing to do nowadays is a lot of people go, well, I got to mention my family, got to mention this. And I go, well, if selfishly, just about me, if it's just about me, mm-hmm. I mean, you know, for my career, which is what I love to do, that was an amazing time. Not to say that this is an amazing time, but I wouldn't have this if not for that. I have to be honest. This show wouldn't have been given to us if not for the fact that we had the success. So there you go. Congratulations to me. 2002, I'm going to say. It's a great year, 2002.
So say, guys, have you heard the new Metallica? What do you think?
Ooh, I have not. Thank you for asking.
I have.
And what do you think?
4 for 4, baby.
Ooh, nice.
So they've released four cuts that you love. I mean, that's practically an album.
At this point, the rest of it could be a steaming pile of turds, and I would be fine with this record. I'd be like, it's a great Metallica record. You have four good songs on an album? That's a success, if you ask me.
This is so wild, by the way. This is how it's done.
What's that?
You know, they used to release 45s back in the day, and that's how you had to get it. You know, you buy the single, whatever, and now you just drop it, stream it, and people can just get it, you know, as we're waiting for the new album to drop. And that's just like I'm old enough to remember the old ways that things used to get released and people get excited.
Yeah, it's still the same concept, though, putting out a couple songs to get you wet your whistle before an album comes out.
Yeah, you don't get the bad B-side. Remember the B-sides were like, okay, this is not a good song because
sometimes
it's on
the B-side turned out to be the... I was just reading... I read the headline. I didn't read the article. But the article...
At least you admitted.
I know. Is about how KISS was mad, I guess, because a radio personality or DJ got a single of one of their songs and the B-side was Beth and ended up going with Beth because they thought that was a better song. And the band was like, what the hell? That's not the song. That's not our single. That's just a B-side. And it turned out to be, still to this day, when it comes to commercial success, the most successful KISS song ever made.
I had no idea that was the case. I didn't know Beth was a B-side.
I'll tell you more, but I didn't read the article.
Oh, yeah. Well, and for you folks that don't know, there were 45 records, and you guys know vinyl. And with a 45, there's only one song on one side, but then there's a whole other side that you could put something on. So they would put, obviously, not a great song because they want to be able to have all the hits on separate 45s for us to buy. So you wouldn't put two hits on the same thing. You could make more money the other way. Well, like Steve just said, accidentally, whatever how it happened, whatever their hit was, Beth was the one, and they could have actually released Beth later and they could have made more money if they were smart. Instead, they were mad.
Yeah, apparently they were pissed at the DJ when they played the B-side, and that ended up becoming their number one hit.
Boy, that was back in the day where you had certain radio personalities that had an ear for music.
Yeah.
And they just knew.
Well, and double whammy, because, you know, that band always had issues with each other, and that song was Peter Criss's song.
Yeah.
So all of a sudden, like, Gene and Paul, who are, like, the brains of the band, are like, we've been cranking out all these great songs, and we're like, the one song that becomes the big hit is a song by the drummer that they probably didn't even like.
And probably didn't want to pay a whole lot to either.
Right.
Yeah. So Metallica, of course, this is their fourth single, if you will, and album's coming out very soon, next month, April 14th, 72 Seasons. Here's the latest tune,
it's the title track, meaning it's...
Oh, it is? Oh, it is? Oh, it says, there it is, now I know why. This is the title track. Thank you, Steve. 72 Seasons is the song from the album of the same name. video. You know,
apparently
again,
it's a 7 minute. It's like a 7 minute long song. Too.
Whoa,
so that's just a taste.
Look at that video. It's such an unfair fight when you think that they have all this money that they can make the video that looks that cool.
I could do that on my iPhone, no problem.
Could you really? Oh wow, I didn't know you were that talented.
Oh yeah, they got apps for that.
Yeah, that's a hell of an app they got there for that. I'll tell you. So anyway, yeah, April 14th, 72 seasons will be dropping, but that's the latest one, the title track.
Dude, that's a couple weeks away.
Yeah. You're going to have the whole thing. And hopefully it's not a steaming pile. Hopefully it's better
than
that.
Well, at this point, I'm okay with that. Right. I got at least four songs I'll enjoy.
I think they
want one of them 7 minutes long, so it's okay.
Yeah. Wow. 7 minutes, man. There you go. All right. Well, we have a big question to answer, and it has nothing to do with Metallica and everything to do with Ryan Castle. What do Ryan Castle and Noodles have in common? Well, I'm going to tell you at 9:50 on The Rock.
BJ and Migs, mornings on The Rock, 99.9 KISW. And now, the Ryan Castle question of the day.
What do Ryan Castle and Noodles have in common?
A sucking sound.
Yeah.
I like more slurping than sucking, but I got you.
Sure.
Okay, well, that's a private conversation you could have. But, yeah.
Oh, someone said Steve slurps both. Steve likes both better when they're a little al dente.
Oh, that's
all right.
Okay.
A little firm.
Yes.
Not a bad thing. Hey, you guys know Cup of Noodles, right?
Yes.
How about they got a new flavor? Sure.
Isn't it just Cup Noodles? It's not Cup O' Noodles. Isn't that the thing?
It is actually just Cup Noodles. You're right.
Yeah, but we've always called, I think at one point maybe it was called that, and no one's ever given up on that.
Oh yeah, so they was Cup of Noodles before, and they changed this to Cup Noodles?
It's just Cup Noodles.
Who the hell's calling it Cup Noodles?
Us.
No one.
No one. That's the most bizarre name change I've ever seen. But okay, Cup Noodles just debuted a new flavor that's apparently not an April Fool's joke. This is the real thing. Breakfast flavored ramen is basically what it is. And
it's only Cup O' Noodles on St. Patrick's Day.
Top of the morning, have a cup of noodles, me boy. Apparently, though, it tastes good. It tastes just like sausage, eggs, pancakes, and syrup. It really does taste like that.
Kind of in for trying it.
Yeah, I'm in for trying it.
Yeah, I'm sure it's healthy.
Oh, that's for sure. At least
of course it's healthy.
High in protein.
Ryan Castle, he's healthy. He's got a 12-pack.
BJ and Migs, mornings on The Rock, 99.9 KISW.
Today's podcast was brought to you by Travis Gagne, bankruptcy attorney. He's here right now and has agreed to answer more of your questions about bankruptcy. How much does bankruptcy cost?
Well, bankruptcy costs, of course, vary depending on what type of case you're filing. There's a certain amount of court costs and other out-of-pocket costs that you're going to have in any case. The filing fees in a bankruptcy case are about $300, whether you file Chapter 7 or Chapter 13. One of the things to watch out for when you're shopping for bankruptcy attorneys or looking at the different cost options is that a lot of times, especially the really cheap places, don't tell you upfront about all the court costs and whatnot that you're going to have to pay in addition to the attorney fees. So make sure that you get the full picture when you're comparing prices of bankruptcy lawyers on what the attorney fees are, how much your court costs are going to be, so that you can really make a true comparison.
Thanks, Travis. If you have more questions about bankruptcy, you can reach out to Travis anytime at choosetherightchapter.com.
T-Mobile's network can help keep you connected to all your favorite podcasts when you're out and about. Whether you're an early bird looking to dive into a daily news podcast or a night owl who wants to catch up on the latest reality TV drama, T-Mobile will keep you connected on their strong and reliable network. T-Mobile covers more highway miles with 5G than anyone. So if you need great coverage, especially when you're on the go, check out T-Mobile. Find out more at T-Mobile.com/CY. That's SEEWHY.
Know a high schooler who's a natural leader? They may be the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society's next Student Visionary of the Year. Candidates in our program gain valuable life skills like leadership, project management, and communication, all while supporting blood cancer research and care. Help your student boost that college application and stand boldly against blood cancer. Learn more or nominate a student at lls.org/student-visionaries. That's lls.org/student-visionaries.
If you need rehab after surgery, help at home, or if you need a place to enjoy the best years of your life after 60,
Carriage is here for you. Carriage is a family-owned healthcare and senior living company that puts people first. Let us provide you with short-term, post-acute rehabilitation at one of our skilled nursing facilities in Bellevue and Renton. Expert in-home care and support to clients throughout Washington. Or enjoy a vibrant retirement in elegant, amenity-rich surroundings in Washington and California. Learn more at Carriage.com.
Did you know CD rates are having a moment? If you've been looking in the wrong places, you might have missed that CD rates are the best they've been in 15 years. No joke. It's the right time to find rates in your best interest because better rates allow your money to earn more money. CD Valet brings you the clearest picture of today's rates, all compiled in one place. Ditch the BS of biased rate shopping and visit CDValet.com to see today's straight-up rates.